Guys,
Evil, give me 2 minutes. I'm gonna go check the weather, and
you got it.
I'll be right back.
Though. All right.
It's all right. Thundering out here. I'll be right back.
Thunder. Hi, everybody. Yeah, stream starting. So I'm gonna deafen you guys for a minute. I'll be right back. Go do what you gotta do. And hi, everybody. I think we're up. It looks like we're up. So welcome, everybody. Very short intro for tonight. So welcome to The Dark Side with Evil Twin. That's me. It's Thursday, and we're doing our Rift Run thing again. So we're off for that. I got the whole Fellowship of the Bling thing going on again, I guess. I don't know. That kind of was, like, cool. Last week, it was kind of fun. So I was enjoying that. Yes, the Fellowship of the Bling is back. You're absolutely right. And I had to mute everybody in the Discord for right now, just so I could say hi and talk to everybody for a minute. So so welcome in. We're going to continue to run Rift for the next couple of hours. It's I'm a little late getting started just because we were trying to get to some place where we could rest and switch over. So Evil gives Evil a flirty wave. Well, thank you very much for that. How are you? So hopefully you can all hang out with us. We kind of just got the full group full, so we're going to continue to go from here and see how far we can get. I don't know if we're going to get through everything tonight. We got a bit of a different raid makeup, as I was saying, different folks coming in tonight, which is kind of what's fun about this. This is a sort of a sideshow thing. This is not necessarily everybody's main thing that we're doing as far as this kinship is concerned or this raid group is concerned. It's people trying new classes and just having fun with it. But it's a level 50 cap, so it makes it different, and we get to enjoy these fights again, and hopefully you all enjoy them as well. So So without further ado, I will return us back to the raid and whatever. Just a couple of notes. Yeah, Fellowship of the Bling. Yes, we got the whole bling thing going on. So, a couple of things. Like we talked about before, there are some still, I'm going to plug the game and all that kind of stuff because I do that. So, and I said do also because you can all make a thing out of that. But there's still some sales going on, so check those out in the Lotro store because it definitely helps to support the game that we all love so much and that the development and all of that kind of stuff. Mithril coins are still on sale until tomorrow, till today or whatever. Today was also the first day of year 4 of the scavenger hunt quest, which I have not even had a chance to check out yet. So, so for those of you who are checking those out, yeah, there's enough new memes in my Discord. That is true. Yeah, you can go check that out on my channel. Thanks to Gussie Moose, by the way, for all that coming in as well. Yeah, we had a lot of fun with just the Kin House move stuff today. We still haven't decorated it, but we did that. So, yeah, so if you're interested in things like, the premium housing and stuff, which requires Mithril coins, definitely go, go buy Mithril coins while they're on sale. They're all 20% off right now. So no, I don't work for Lotro or I don't work for SSG or anything like that. I like to see people actually, helping to support the game. So that's all good. Hey, Shale, took about 4 hours to do year 4 solo. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. And hey, DeMay, how are you? Hi, Strider. So, yeah, go check that out. Apparently, the new sales that are coming up for the next week, there's storage and all that kind of stuff, which is great for me because I'm such a pack rat. I am the king of pack rats when it comes to that kind of stuff. So, yeah, storage is always a necessity for me. So I usually wait till it's on sale. So there you go. Yes, new sale incoming is for bag and vault space. So definitely check that out. So, so I'm going to go back on the Discord here, and we will make sure everybody's ready, and then we will continue with our raid. And hopefully you'll all enjoy this, so sit back and enjoy, and we'll see where we go from here. Hey, guys, can you all hear me now?
Yep.
In the Discord?
Yeah, how dare you mute us? How dare
you? I got to do the shtick, right? I got to do the whole intro shtick, right?
So, you can do it with us. You don't want this.
You were all like, blah, 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 blah. Raid leader privilege. All right, so I'm gonna. Here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna do a quick ready check because I want to see who is actually still here, and who went away. Wait, I did say go do a bio and stuff right now because now would be a good time to do it.
One sec. I need to alt tap into the game again. Ready.
And I'm gonna eat pizza.
I hate
you're gonna
you,
watch yeah. me eat pizza.
Share pizza, please. I want that quest.
All right, I'm back, you guys. I tried
Welcome
to
back.
As I could.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my god, the lightning is insane.
Awesome. I love storms.
Yeah, very, but I'm in the middle of the raid. I'm in the middle of the raid, though. I don't want to. You guys see me disappear unexpectedly, you'll know why.
All right, so Throw Me is still away, so once Throw Me gets back, we should be good to go.
Again?
Apparently.
I gave the dogs. I took them outside, and then I gave them some cream cheese in their bone. So.
Yeah, it's Cookie Mama's right.
They had cream cheese in the bone in the lightning, or?
No, inside the house.
I can literally smell pizza.
Oh, shut up about the pizza.
Well,
Gussie, look, I'm eating pizza.
That's okay, because I have shrimp in the refrigerator. I'm going to nibble on some shrimp cocktail.
Yeah, but that's not pizza.
It's not pizza. Unless it's shrimp pizza.
No, it's not shrimp pizza.
So I've been smart that I knew Andrew was going to do his 12-hour stream today. So so I made pizza this morning. Made the dough, let it rest, all kinds of cool stuff. And then I only had to put it in the oven earlier. So that's good thinking right there.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm going to go over the fight. Is there anybody that's in the raid tonight that has not been on one of these Rift Raids with us before? Because honestly, I don't know if there's somebody that hasn't been here before. Maybe you're on a different character, that's okay. But is there anyone who has not been on a Rift Raid ever? Like,
never
the way that we're doing it. What's that?
That would be me.
Okay. Well, welcome. It's always...
Welcome to the Rift.
Okay. So the way that this fight goes is main tank is going to go in and tank bars. We'll let him get some aggro built up. And then there's three phases of adds that come in. The first phase is going to be a troll keeper and a troll. Same standard thing there. Kill the troll keeper, kill the troll. So off tank. Now I'm going to let Hunzi and David figure out who's going to do which one. All right. Who's taking main tank?
I don't mind. Hunzi, do you have a preference for main or off tank for
whatever,
this fight?
Whatever you prefer, David.
Okay.
I don't care. So it's your call.
All right. I'll do it. I'll give it a shot.
Okay.
Well,
all right.
Yeah,
so
which one will you give a shot? Main or off tank?
The main one.
Oh, main tank. Okay. Yes.
Mm-hmm. So Hunzi will be main tank. That means David will be the off tank. So David, your job is to scoop up all the adds when they come in.
Yep.
Gather them all up. And then we will get on. For the first one, we will all get on the troll keeper, kill the troll keeper, and then kill the troll. Main healer in this case is Misadventure. So you're going to your main job is going to be healing Hunzi while he's tanking bars. Off healer is Throw Me, so you'll be handling the rest of the group and extras on main tank if needed.
In that case, I would suggest swapping Throw Me and Mrs. Venture since Hunzi is in the group with Throw Me and I'm in the group with Mrs. Venture. So maybe.
Oh, my bad. Okay, that's right, because you guys swapped responsibilities. Yep. So how about if I just swap groups for the two of you? And what's that, Bink?
All I want to get, do not fall on Misadventure. We've learned that the minstrel gets all the aggros all the time.
Okay. No, that's going to be up to Throw Me. That's harmless, so hopefully he's here and heard that. So, second group is going to be Slave Master... and some slave men and a slave. Yes, is there a slave in the second group, or is that only in the third group? Somebody remind me.
I th- think.
The third group has both. I don't know if it's a slave or a slave master that comes in the second.
Third the second, I believe, is only a slave master, but not a slave. So the idea there is pick up the slave master, kill him, kill all the ads.
Yeah.
And then the third group is going to be slave master, slave, and ads. Yeah. So you got to pick. We're going to have to make sure that we take down the slave. So I'll make sure that I'm doing that because I'll take her out when that time comes. So I'll take that responsibility. And again, same thing there. Slave master first, then all the workers, then the slave. And that's it.
So easy peasy. All I need to do is just grab bars, correct?
You're going to grab bars and you're going to keep a hold of bars as much as you can. Now, he will run away on occasion. He will run away on occasion to go smack somebody randomly and he will come back to you. So you don't really need to change your positioning of where you're tanking him. You don't want to go run off because he'll come back to you because you have the aggro. So you just want to stay where you want to be for when he comes back.
Okay.
The other thing everybody needs to remember is that when we are fighting bars in between waves of ads, he will do something called gnaw your bones. When he does that, if you see it in the chat, call it out. That will basically be a big pounding AoE on the ground. And if you are in the area, he will beat the shit out of you. So basically, if you hear gnaw your bones, get away from him. Just run away from him. And he'll just stand there and do that until he's done doing it.
Is there a preference? You want me to take him or just where he is?
I've got a preference for you, Hanzi. Evil. But if you can tank him more or less where he is now, so that when the ads come spawning in, I can grab them away without drawing the aggro of bars as well with my AoE taunts.
Yes. Yep. You want to keep him in the area that he is generally in right now, which is over by the chest.
Okay.
All right. So when you grab the aggro, you're going to get the aggro and you're going to turn him away from where we are now and you'll tank him from the other side and you're basically just going to hold him there as best as you can until and we'll beat on him until the ads come and you know how it goes from there. So
make sure you get race buffs
started.
All right. So we do need scrolls and tokens. Let me make sure that Harmless is back. So ready, check. Make sure everybody's here.
Throw me his back. He just walked to where we are.
Okay, very good.
Yep.
He was back at the rock pillar.
So I will do scroll and tokens for my group, unless somebody's already putting them up. No, we're good. Okay, so I'll get them for my group, which is group one. If somebody wants to do the same for group two, that would be handy.
Group two still has them.
Okay.
For another 20 minutes or so.
Okay, we should be good then. All right, and just remember, let Hunzi get some aggro built up before we start digging into bars, and we should be good.
Ooh.
All right, let's do it.
Okay, there we go.
Whenever you're ready. Wait for him to build up aggro, guys. Okay, whenever you're ready, Hunzi.
All right, good to go.
Yep.
Okay.
All right, let's get in. Get away, get away, get away, gnaw your bones. Everybody get away.
Go back, now.
Yep, not yet, no, he's still doing it. He's still doing it. You're all gonna take damage. No power is
stronger than bars. Okay, I'm back in.
All right, well, we just lost two. So this is, let's see if we can get people up and salvage it.
I got one.
Somebody watching for ads? I know he'll say it, but just keep an eye out for them. Alright, here we go. Ads. My target, Troll Keeper.
You said he'll randomly smack someone.
Yep, he'll smack someone and then he'll come back to you. Unless you've lost aggro.
On him at the moment. No, he's back.
Alright, yep. We gotta try to pull this Troll Keeper away from bars, please. Pull him back. Pull him back. Now we've swapped aggro.
Gnaw your bones.
Get away.
Get back.
Get away. All right. Troll keeper's down. Everybody on the troll over here. Yeah, we're having a hard time with the aggro tonight. All right. All reds. Go reds in my group if you're here.
No power is stronger than Mars.
So he's run off now just for random aggro.
Yeah, he runs off and then he'll come right back.
Yep, and you see he's coming right back to you. See how that goes?
Okay, yeah, troll is down. Troll's down.
All right, let's get back on bars.
I'm just going to keep him in between these two objects.
Yep, that's fine.
Advantageous for us.
All right, we're going to watch for that next group.
Come slow, deal with these worms. Okay,
here we go.
That's...
Yep, they're coming. They're coming. Where's the troll? Where's the slave master? Or is it just workers? Oh, it's a slave.
Just workers and a slave.
All right, I will mez the slave. Nobody touched the slave. Oh, she's got a dot on her.
What kind of dot does she have?
I don't know, but she's down right now. But she's like right in the middle of the crowd, so I will keep her down and occupied.
Okay, and I'll. Okay.
Kill all the workers.
Not your bones.
Gnaw your bones, okay. Get away from him. Get out. Okay.
Ah, I got smashed. Can you grab me, bone?
I use my combat race.
Okay.
Slave is up. Are the workers down yet?
One more to go, I think.
Okay.
Nope.
No, two.
Okay, workers down.
Okay, nope. On the slave.
Oh, one more. I'm sorry.
Okay, all right, that's fine.
I just saw it.
That's fine.
Slave?
It's on the slave.
Okay.
No power is stronger than Mars.
Try and pull bars back into that corner if you can. Back where he started.
Okay, slaves down.
Alright, slaves down.
Gnaw your bones.
Gnaw your bones, get away, get away.
Oh, sir, I see.
Everyone
just
get away.
I'm all right. Freezing.
Yeah, okay, yeah, Hunzi's down.
Okay,
so everybody...
Hunzi's down, so I'll take over main.
Yep, take over main. Okay, ads. Everybody on my target, the slave master. We gotta find the slave. Where is she? Is there a slave here or just the slave master?
There should be a slave somewhere. She's probably back healing or something.
No, I don't see a slave.
Alright, interrupt him, interrupt him. Alright, everybody on the slave master. We can try and salvage this.
I've just targeted the slave master to help.
That's fine. Thank you. Alright, on the ads. Clean up all the ads.
Hail folks.
No power is stronger than Mars.
Up here comes the slave in now.
Alright, slave's coming in now. She gets stuck somewhere?
No.
Where is she?
Slave is,
There she is, okay.
Down.
All right, I will keep the slave down.
Well, she's all that. Oh, I just saw another. She's all that's up is the slave, huh?
Is that all that's left? Yeah. All right, kill the slave.
One worker, but it's fine.
Okay, kill. Kill the slave.
What's it? Okay, kill the slave. Okay.
Yes, my target. Kill the slave. Reds.
We're fine. We're pretty much
We're good.
Kill condition at this
point. We're okay at this point, but Gussie and that aggro draw.
Sorry. I was just trying to kite her.
Alright, everybody back on bars. Let's kill him.
Yeah, he's almost done.
Get out.
Yep. Gnaw your bones. Is that gnaw your bones or no?
No.
No, just okay.
No power is stronger than bars.
He's down. Job, all right, Chris. Good job, everybody. Wow, okay, that was
well done, guys.
That was a good save. All right.
Let's get everyone up.
Yeah, get everybody up. That was exciting.
That was fun. No, seriously, it was fun.
It was. It actually was, yeah. It was dramatic.
I just like how Slate on that last wave CCs herself by sitting there casting a heal immediately.
Yeah, yeah.
As she enters.
Ooh.
All right,
I'm
so.
Heal, man.
All right, so here's. Right click. There we go.
Very evade rating. Sweet.
If everyone wants to group up on me, I'll put another duty band out there because I'm off timer on that.
All right. So here, I just linked in raid chat. There are all of the items that are in the chest at the moment. The sapphire is for the boots. So if you do not have the boots for your Rift raid set yet, and you would like the boots, then go ahead and do a slash roll.
I already got it.
Yeah, if you already have the boots, I prefer that you try for this character. They are account bound, but I like it if this is your main and this is the one you're playing for this group for now and you don't have them, then go ahead and do a slash roll. I'm going to roll for him. And I failed.
Aww.
Nice.
And I
so, anyone else who's interested in having the boots? Silvig with a 73 right now is the big roll. Now, what we also usually say is if you get one of the gems in here, then try not, you know, we would like to try to spread the wealth as we come around in here. So if you win one, then, you know, we'll have you hold off on the rest of them. But you can still have some of the other stuff that shows up too. All right. Any more rolls? Going once? Going twice? All right, Sylvig gets the near-perfect sapphire for the Rift Boots. Congratulations.
Congrats.
All right, the rest of the items that are here, there's a barrel shard, there's a few other items, there's the star mace, there's a couple of two-handed weapons that are in here as well. I would suggest you turn off the always loot all if you're going to dig into the chest.
I made that mistake once.
Yeah, because then you grab everything and it's all, everything's, a lot of it's buying on equip, but you know, if you want to leave stuff for everybody else, it's always a good idea.
Yeah, we
to
don't
do want to
have
anymore.
Any technical difficulties today.
Is there anyone who needs or wants the Great Benefactor? If not, I'd like it for cosmetic purposes, but if you can actually use it as improvement on your current weapon, then go for it.
Share the mushroom quest. Yes, I can.
Oh, I did it earlier.
Binkles came late.
Sorry, I got a handful of peanuts I'm working on.
That's okay, I got pizza.
Shut up.
Do you have a handful of pizza?
That would get kind of messy. You know, all sort of squishy so and whatever. Fun. So, apologize for not paying attention to the chat during the fights. So, I will try and come back to read the chat and stuff. So, what's that point talking about? This game is such a face roll now? Yeah, okay, sure.
Kappa.
Try playing it at level 50, right? Although Half Pint's been around a long time, so I'm sure that she knows how to do everything we're doing right now.
Does
too. Come on, you guys, this way.
Yes. So to back to the giant room, and then we'll go up to go do Zerm. And
oh my God, this thunder is just amazing sounding.
Is it coming from Australia? Because that would be the thunder down under.
Oh.
That's terrible.
Oh my God. Go in the corner.
I thought maybe Hunzi might appreciate that. I don't know.
Yeah.
He's like,
I'll let you know next time there's thunder of it. It'll be a bit of a delay. Being in the future.
Damn, was that a real thunder boom or was that just the giant over there?
I think.
Dude, don't go near the giant. Right. Leave those all alone. We're gonna go upstairs over this way. I've been playing this game so long, my kin was server first Balrog 2.0 after the remake. Very nice.
Oh, Brad's
well,
here,
welcome,
man.
Welcome to our Rift Raid tonight. I'm sure this probably brings back fond memories. I've played since the very beginning of the game. I'm a 10-year player, and you know, I enjoyed doing the Rift back in the day as well. So I was actually with the group that did server first on Landerval. For the Balrog, so for a first kill. So that was a lot of fun. I didn't know it at the time, I was along with the group for the ride on my champion. And I actually, they finally killed the Balrog in this fight, and I'm like, oh, that was cool. I was dead, you know, because I didn't know to get out of the way of certain things, and I'm just laying there dead on the ground. And it turns out that was like server first kill. So I was like, oh, wow, that's okay. I didn't know what that meant at the time, but that was a big deal. I was such a noob. I never played an MMO before this game, so yeah. All right, next group up here is Slave Master and some Pale Folk. So let's just go take them out.
Pale Folk.
Yep, little fire. Interrupt.
Somebody say fire.
Interrupt him. He buffed them all. You can all die now.
Yeah.
Did he buff the Pale Folk or no? He buffed himself. So he's hitting pretty hard right now, but.
Yeah,
but we'll make it.
Yeah, you all do realize that when he has that little glowy orange circle around him that he's doing an induction, right? I just want to ask the question because maybe somebody doesn't understand that.
No.
That's what that is. So you have to interrupt that.
The only problem is that I, as a warden, don't have an immediate interrupt. I need to build it up gambit-wise.
Yeah, that's the
same. Oh, really? Okay, so wardens don't have it?
I need to do two gambits.
Okay. Yeah.
Or so, else use the... I think it's... What is it? Spear and shield, I think.
Yeah, I can use the gambit shortcut, but I need to clear... First my gambit thing, then use the shortcut, and then...
If you've got gambits already lined up in there, you need to clear them out, and then, it's two or three minutes.
It takes too much time for a warden, so I can't do it.
There's something you can do, as a warden, to preset a gambit as a backup. I always like to have a stun available or an interrupt, so you can do your, you do two goes.
Yeah, battle memory.
Yeah, exactly. Battle memory. That's what it's called. Right. So you do your battle memory and set that right off the bat with a interrupt. So
Slave Master's the next one.
No, we're gonna go to the right here. Yeah. There's a whole bunch of Pale Folk in the corner. So just come take these Pale Folk. Everybody down into the corner and just kill all the Pale Folk here.
Ah, cool. I'm good at the corner.
No, we're all going
go to the corner, Hunzi.
Corner of shame.
I'm in the corner.
Fire.
Fire!
Fireball!
Disco Inferno?
Nah. Not tonight.
I have that clip. I can post it in chat.
Alright, I'm gonna pull the Slave Master who's by himself there. I'm gonna pull him in, so just let's pick him up. Now. Hello, Fusion Crayfish. Welcome to the stream.
Hello. Welcome, welcome.
Always nice to see new names. I say new names because, you know, normally you're like, oh, it's always great to see a new face at a party or something like that. It's like, well, we can't see faces, so we just see new names, but that's all good. All right, so, so next group is, let's do this. We're going to pull this group over to the left. There is a Slave Master, and there is a slave in there, I think.
I can stun one if you want.
Let's... What's that?
I don't see a slave.
I thought there was, but just maybe I'm wrong.
Master.
Yeah, just a Slave Master.
Yes.
So
slave
go ahead
master.
And do the pull, and then Gamer Gramp, just mez the Slave Master if you can. Or I got him. Don't. Or just kill. Oh, we can just kill him. That's right. We want to kill him first. My bad. We just want to kill him
first. Too many people in the way.
Kill it. Kill it. Kill
it. Here comes the slave.
See, I knew there was a slave.
Just around the corner.
Mezzing slave. Get off the slave. Mezzing slave.
Yeah, get off the slave.
Slave is mezzed.
All right, good. Very good. Thank you. I was pretty sure that there was one, but I didn't see her. She comes from a further away.
Throw me is down, so if somebody can res throw me, that would be great.
He's up.
Okay, cool.
All right, clean up the rest of the stuff.
I'm just turning it around.
Oh, did something just happen there?
Why did somebody go and wake the slave?
Slave.
She's the only one left.
Okay.
Yeah.
She wasn't the only one left at the time, but yeah, she's the only one now, so just go ahead and kill her.
All right, just people shouldn't jump the gun like that.
Yeah, yeah. Don't wake up targets unless you know what you're doing. All right, next next group is going to be a troll keeper and a troll. So I'm going to wait for them to circle back around.
You want me on the troll keeper, Evil?
What's that?
You want me on that troll keeper?
I do. We're going to wait until they make another pass back over this way. I don't want them near all those mobs.
Want me to pull that troll keeper back?
Yep, you can do it right now. Pull him to you.
Okay, incoming.
There you go. Oh, interrupt. Interrupted, good. Everybody on the troll keeper, please.
Okay, I'm bringing him back to the wall here.
Oh, I'm getting the shit beat out of me. On
they
the troll.
Have a cave troll.
They have a cave troll. Yeah, well, they'll teach you to go shooting him up too fast.
Yeah. Oh my god.
He's hitting hard, man.
Can't handle my pew pew.
You can't handle the pew pew. That's right.
The pew pew is strong.
The truth is,
yeah, live. There you go. Live by the rule. You tag it, you bag it. That's right.
You want to see my pew pew?
You want the pew pew? You need that pew pew?
Yeah. All right.
Hey,
so
hey, Gussie, you want to see my pew pew?
No, stop. Official. Shh. PG-13 in here.
Hey, pew pew. It's my bow, or my guy's javelin. Do you want to see
right,
my javelin? All
right. There is a slave here. So where I will take down the slave.
So you want me to just get the rest?
Yep. Go ahead and pull something else, something other than the slave, whenever you're ready.
There we so go. Everybody else, leave the slave.
Oh, she resisted me. Wow.
Got it. Got her.
Nice. Good. Good job.
I can.
Quick
see that.
Draw, Grandpa.
No, it wasn't so much a quick draw. I was ready for it, just in case she resisted.
He was ready for you to fail.
Yeah,
yes,
he was.
Indeed.
Because I don't have any finesse, that's why.
Yeah.
Apparently that's the thing. I have no finesse. Apparently I need more finesse, yes.
It's all about the finesse.
Apparently.
All right, slave is all.
Slave.
Oh, that's good. I think we're getting through these a bit better, Evil.
Well, everybody's a little bit more, I think we were a little rusty getting started tonight, and like I said, everybody's just kind of, we have some people in a different role, which is fine.
Well,
we just make do.
A few weeks.
And
yeah, it's been a couple weeks.
Who haven't done this before, period, so.
We started out with 8 or 9 people instead of 12. That might have something to do with it as well.
Yeah, maybe. All right, guys, why are we picking mushrooms?
Why are we picking mushrooms
and infecting everybody in the group? When we have stuff to kill, please wait.
Yeah.
Everybody will get a mushroom. There are enough mushrooms for everyone, okay? So, I know everybody loves mushrooms here, but, you know.
I know those hobbits like mushrooms, so.
Mushroom stew.
Sure. Blame the hobbits.
Cream of mushroom stew.
Everybody always blames the hobbits.
Oh, that sounds good.
Ooh,
yeah, cream of mushroom soup.
What? Hobbits? Mushroom, roast them, stick them in stew. Oh, no.
Because hobbits.
Squash them and make them into jelly.
Ew.
Everyone will get a mushroom. Sounds like a threat. Nice shit. Okay. I think all the mushrooms have been picked up at this point. So this is pretty much the same fight as before. All right. There's really nothing different to this fight. Now, the only thing that Feck had taught me the last time we did this is, Hunzi, what you're going to want to do is if you're going to tank him like you did last time, you're going to grab the aggro and you're going to pull him all the way down this end where I'm jumping, and you're going to tank him here. Yep. And the reason being is because some of the adds come from behind his current location, so it makes it easier to sort them out when we have to actually mez and kill stuff. So we're going to let Hunzi do the grab and pull him all the way down here before anybody touches him. All right. And then we'll all get on bars down this, or Zerm down this end. Okay?
Yeah. I need 1 second before we start.
One.
I'm just building up something.
Your 1 second is up.
And one.
I do have an emergency 15-second daze AoE. So.
Okay.
Is that your Bane Flare? Now? Isn't that your Bane Flare?
Bane Flare. Mm-hmm.
Which used to be a dead only.
Undead only. Yes, yes. It's much more useful now.
I can imagine. So, welcome to everybody that's in the chat, in case maybe you joined us late. Welcome to Lotra Stream Thursday night. We are doing a level 50 on level rift run with our kinship over on Brandywine. So hopefully you can hang around for a while and enjoy this. We're having a good time doing it. We're on boss number 2 at the moment, so we're just kind of working our way through stuff. So, all right, I'm going to do a ready check and make sure we're all here and good to go.
One thing I was wondering about, he's got the buff, debuff, I don't know, that's called Ire of Bars, but what does ire mean?
Anger? Basically, he's pissed off because he killed his brother.
Oh, okay. Makes sense.
Alright. Now, supposedly, the rumor was that whoever got the killing blow on Bars somehow becomes the target of Zerm for his ire. I don't know if there's any truth to that, but
that would be cool.
I don't know. Who actually did get the killing blow? Does anybody know?
Not a freaking clue.
I'd be curious, because that would mean that that would mean that, you know, we would kind of know who to look out for, but I don't know.
It might be me, since I was tanking him and I had quite a few different dots on him, so yeah. Might be, don't know.
We'll try that next time. Maybe we'll check it out. We'll see.
All right.
So same general idea here. Do we have scrolls and tokens up, or do we need them again? I have 20 minutes on my group. I don't know if anybody went down or needs scrolls.
We're 27 minutes here.
Yeah,
I checked it. Our group. I just popped some new hope tokens since some of us were out of it. So
okay. All right. Sounds good.
Next 30 minutes.
All right. Very good.
More or less.
All right. So let's do it then. Everybody let... let Hunzi grab the aggro and pull him all the way down here, and we'll be off and running again. And same thing, the waves of adds are the same, so we're going to treat them all the same way.
Yep, and I'll grab the adds again.
Make a path!
Out of my way. Hey! I believe...
Don't hit him yet. Let Hunzi get him in position. See? You're all starting too soon. He's hitting
bird
the bird.
Got aggro. What the
hell? Yeah, well, because how did the bird get aggro away
from
Hunzi?
It's a freaking bird.
Secondary target things.
Yeah. Is it about he?
Yeah, it's all good. All right, so let's go ahead and do it. Let's start hitting him. And we'll keep an eye out for that first set of adds, which is going to be a troll keeper and a troll. Hey, druids.
Hey, druids.
It's druids fire. Yay. Fire?
Fire. You will tremble before your end.
All right, here they come. Okay. First group, my target is the troll keeper.
now? Why is he running off? He randomly runs off?
Yeah, he will do that. Yeah, same as Bars does.
Okay. Come back, Jack.
All right, everyone should be on the Troll Keeper right now. All right, on the Troll.
Except Hanzi, of course.
Everybody on the Troll.
Oh, wait, I'm blind.
Troll is down, so back on Zerm.
Should be new ads momentarily.
Okay, that's...
Ads coming, okay.
Slave out in front.
Yep, I got her. She's Mez. Don't touch her, don't touch her. Let everything else come in.
I just... cramming aggro here.
Is there a slave master? I don't believe so.
Slave masters in the next round.
Okay. Just want to make
nice.
Sure.
Thank you for grouping them all together.
Yep. Yeah. Yes, fire is good. Keep them all together here.
Fire?
Fire. All right, I'm going to go take care of her. Oh, she's up. I knew that was going to happen.
Stay off the slave. Ah,
she's coming in. She's coming in. I will take care of her. Hang on.
I think we got everything, boss.
Oh, no.
There's little pale folk coming in.
Oh, slave master, come in.
All right, yeah, get the slave master. I will keep the slave down. Everybody stay on the slave master.
There's another slave. I got her.
Really? Oh, that's third wave.
Yeah.
Shit. Okay, all right. We're going to have to... Yeah, you're going to have to keep her down until everything else is dead.
Somebody woke her up. Shit. No AoEs. Yeah, no AoEs. She's in a very bad position. Damn it.
Yeah, so is mine. Mine's like right next to Zerg.
Well, I need to use AoEs or else I can't keep aggro on them. Sorry.
That's fine. You go ahead and if you're aggro and stuff, go ahead and do it.
Just get the slave master down. Number
yeah,
one.
Slave master is really the big important thing. Everybody almost stay down. On that. Because if he buffs everything, we're in big trouble.
Your slave master's
get
done.
Single workers, guards, etc.
Yep, get the little stuff now, and then we'll clean up the slaves.
I don't see any more little ones.
There's a slave that's already up. The slave that's in the middle of the room is already up right now. I'm going to keep the other one down.
God. Yeah, I've been having a really hard time keeping her under control.
Yep.
Norse slave.
I got the slave. All right, other slave is back here behind Zerm.
You will tremble before the end.
So
it loves me.
Come to me. Come to me, my target, please. The slave.
I keep getting stunned. It's annoying as hell.
Yeah, you gotta. Well,
I'm stunned too.
Well, yeah, you gotta keep stun immunity on the tanks if we can. I know Gramp's been busy with other things.
No, a little busy.
Good on the interrupts. Good job.
Okay.
All right, slave is down. Kill Zerm.
Zerm.
Okay. Nice.
Well done. Good job, you guys.
Good job, everybody.
Well done.
Yeah, I ended up switching to a sword instead of my spear. So I get more parry on that.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so let me open the chest up here.
I didn't die. Woo-hoo.
Nice. All right, so we've got... There's another gem for the boots. And there's a nice teal in here. It's a thick gold ring as a teal with 6% tactical crit multiplier. God, I remember how you'd covet something like that back in the day, right? All right, so if you don't have the boots, same deal as before. If you don't have the boots, go ahead and do a roll. Not much better.
K. Can you give me 2 6 evil just so I can top my drink up, if that's cool?
Yeah, go for it. All right, are you rolling?
2 6 No. No?
Okay.
I'm all... Thank you.
I can't believe my bird stole aggro. What's up with that?
You should rename it.
So War's got a 90. Anybody else rolling for the... anybody else going to roll for the boots?
Nope.
No thanks.
Okay.
Now, my first trip in here,
mm-hmm.
I got something. I don't remember what it was. It wasn't the boots. I don't remember what gem I got, though. So... I think I turned it in. Would it be under instances and skirmishes, or?
No, it wouldn't. If you had the you mean for in your inventory?
In my wallet.
I think it shows up under instances and skirmishes. Yeah. Yes.
That's where I can find it.
Yeah, you'd see it in there. And it is account shareable, so you can share it on the account. All right.
May I have the bow if anybody else doesn't want it?
Yeah, hang on a sec. Wait. Easy there, Chief.
Sorry.
All right. The thick gold ring is a bind on acquire item. So is there anybody that wants that thick gold ring that you can use it for your character? Because it's bind on acquire, so it's this character.
Nope.
Anybody want that in particular?
Nope, negative.
It's tactical crit. So, tactical classes are the ones who are going to want it, but...
Am I a tactical class?
No.
No, tactical's mage classes.
Because, yeah. You know, it's better than what I've got, so, you know.
Lore master, runekeeper, minstrel.
Yeah.
Capital.
Well, does fire and light damage not count as a tactical thing?
I don't know.
Well, so it does, but...
It does, so... Just...
Like, it's such a small subset of your... Well, I guess not if you have...
Well, not if Gus is wearing light oils and...
I don't think it counts it like that, though.
Yeah, I don't think it does.
Uses physical and then applies it as fire damage.
Yeah, okay.
Is anybody else interested in that bow? I'm going to give it to Gussie if no one is.
Okay. Which bow? The West Wind.
The West Wind bow? Yeah.
No.
Okay.
Thank you.
It's all yours, Gussie. All right, I'm going to leave the rest of it in the chest. You may help yourself as you see fit. And then we will work our way back and go to the next area. What are we all talking about? Ooh, nice lag spike.
Wait, where are we going?
Back up the ramp the way we came, and then we'll go back down into the room where the giant is, and then we go through there and down to the giant camp, as opposed to the tiny camp.
I'd say I really liked the way the helmet looks.
Especially the one with the little bunny ears? It's a bunny ear helmet.
It's fun.
It's fun.
Yeah. Yeah, it's cute.
Wait. What's going on? Oh, here's the ramp. Okay.
So read what Maywin said there.
I can't. I'm trying to steer.
I'm trying to eat. That's why I'm not reading it right now.
Fire and light damage counts as tactical damage type. This critical multiplier only applies to tactical damage source.
Ah.
Okay.
Something new.
Thank you.
Welcome back, Hansie. We are up the ramp and back at the giant. Come with me.
And we shall see. Yeah, I'm away.
Whee!
And light and fire oils do not get affected by tactical crit multiplier. Oh. That's interesting.
Oh, you got the Jeff bonus.
I got the Jeff bonus.
Good job, Hunter. Good job.
Do 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 do.
Make sure you grab the, there's the quest here. Hear of the
giant's yeah. Troubles. Oh yeah, I didn't grab it last
Once time. Once they get into combat, you can't actually take the quest, but if somebody has it, we can share it with the rest of the group if we need to, so.
Yeah, I've got it.
Yeah, we're good. There is a barter over here for the Rift coins, if you have stuff to turn in for the coins. The coins can be bartered up top for material up top.
You don't use the scrap of Rift iron ore and the obsidian rock shards for anything, right? Just
no,
to barter
you don't.
For coins.
Yeah.
Just barter.
Yep.
So there's no disadvantage for bartering them.
And that's another 10 coins. Yay.
Watch out in the middle.
Yeah. You probably don't want to stand up there.
Yeah, do we want to do another?
Yep, there they are. Okay, so now that that group just came in, is everybody ready to move? Is everybody here?
Yeah.
No. All right, let's move. Everybody come. Let's move as a group, and we'll go down to the next section. Stay to your right so we don't aggro on the left-hand side there.
Dun, dun, dun. Are you playing the music in this?
No.
The music down here is great.
I've got no sound at the moment.
I have game sounds on, but I don't have any music on. All right, so when we come through this opening, go immediately to the right.
And then we're gonna
get up on this area here. Actually, and over. So just get everybody here. As we say in the raids, be a blob, not a string. You want to kind of move as a big blob.
Hey, no fat jokes, okay?
Excuse me. Round is a shape.
True.
I am a shape.
And I have the looks of a god. Too bad it's a Buddha, but hey.
All right, so ready check. Let's just make sure everybody's here.
Must be those pork chops.
Whoa!
Oh yeah, shit. Or the bacon bits.
Okay, so what we're gonna do is there are scrappers and there are summoners. The summoners are the really important things to get down first. But I think what we'll do is we'll pull these two scrappers here in a minute, and we should be okay with just those. So. Everybody's ready to go, so we'll start pulling these down.
Oh, yeah. About that. 1 second.
Oh, we just woke a few things up.
No worries. I just noticed.
Including a summoner. Summoner. Okay, so the summoner's down, so everybody just focus on this stuff.
Scrapper.
Kill it all.
Ooh.
Kill it with fire.
Something's debuffed me.
Well, just remember that these are fire orcs, so fire is not as effective against them. All right, do not hit my target. Everybody stay off of my target for the moment. I'm just going to mez him again. There we go. Somebody woke up the summoner. All right, watch it. Pull it down, pull down, pull down. Get your pet out of there. Get your pet out of there.
Too late.
All right, well, now we're fighting more.
All
right, I'm mezzing this one. Leave him alone. All right, he's down. Leave him alone. Don't touch him. My target. Everybody should be on my target, the summoner. And we woke up the other summoner again. Huh? Kill this one. I don't know. Somebody's AOEing something up there. They keep waking him up. All right.
I got him down.
All right. He's down. Kill everything else first.
Reveal weakness doesn't break mez, does it? It's broken again.
No, I think, I don't know. There's, I see wind going off up here. I see, like, all kinds of stuff going off up here. Another summoner inbound. Watch him. Yep, and he got just him. Pulled. We just got pulled him. Okay. Yep. Yep. Leave him alone. Leave him alone. Kill all the worms. Kill all the things. Thank you for the continual buzzball. Oh, look,
Worm got the Slayer Advanced.
He summered more. So, nice. What'd you get?
Starting Worm Slayer Advanced.
Oh, good for you. Good job.
Oh, I'm on fire.
Come on, baby, light my fire.
Oh my god, stop.
birds.
No, oh, stop.
Fire.
Evil. Which one do you want to go on?
We got last summoner.
On the summoner, yeah, just this last summoner. Hello, Armageddon. How did I manage to get a group like that? We've been working on it for probably 4 or 5 months now, actually.
Hi, Armageddon.
Yeah,
how are you?
But welcome to the stream. Yeah, I'm guessing you were asking about it.
Welcome to the Nut House.
Yes, welcome to the Crazy House. Indeed. Yes, we are all level 50. We are all not using any legendary items. Everybody, go to the left as you go in here. Please come into the corner in the
to
left.
To the left. To the left.
Yeah, that.
Don't go to the right. To the right.
So. All right, so for this fight, for those of you who haven't been in here before, this is pretty much an easy tank and spank in regards to the boss. It's not that hard. Spanky, spanky. The tough part is that the broken staircase across the way from us, there will be 4 orcs that will spawn occasionally and run down those stairs and jump off, and they will attempt to make their way to the boss. If they get to them to him, they heal him. So essentially what has to happen is when the Gussie, we're going to do the same thing we did before, which is your job is going to be to watch the stairs while you're pew-pewing from over here. Who's going to tank the boss? David or Hunzi?
I'll do it.
Okay. You're going to tank him over near the chest. Okay.
Yep.
The chest is in the corner across from us there. So you're going to tank him over there, Gussie. You're going to stand over here and watch the stairs while you kind of pew-pew the boss, right? And you'll call out when you see the ads coming. And when they do start coming, everybody needs to go over and start taking out the ads. And then once they're all dead, then we get back on the boss and rinse and repeat.
Yeah. Quick question, Evil. Last time, I was here as DPS. Mm-hmm. But the ads, do they respond to force taunts, force deck taunts, or not?
I don't believe they do. I don't believe you can taunt them. I know. I'm pretty sure you can't slow them. We've tried like tar and stuff. Yeah. I forget exactly what the mechanic is.
But it didn't work the first week.
Oh, really? Okay, is that what it was?
Or the last time, not last week.
Okay. Which, what is it that worked? The taunt worked or the tar? The tar worked.
The tar, that's what I was waiting to say. I was just going to say, I think we also put tar down at the bottom of the stairs, and that helped quite a bit.
The goop on the floor.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe the lore master can also put a, what's called the flesh thing that stuns the group, and then we pick out one, and that might help as well.
Then I have a trap, too, so I usually...
The flesh thing, Bane Flare?
Yeah, I think so.
Very little HP.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of health. They go down pretty fast, so it's not a big deal. It's just managing to keep... You just got to kill them before they get to the boss, that's all.
Okay, that's good.
So, real quick, Armageddon's asking about trait tree and stuff, and yeah, I noticed that Cookie Mama... Thank you for mentioning it. Yeah, so for anybody who's wondering, in addition, you know, because obviously the characters are different now than they were back in the original... level 50 stuff. We have trait trees. We do use the trait trees, but we're maxed at 34 points, and that's the most that you can get at level 50 without doing big battles. Big battles would give you an additional 2 if you went through there, but we're trying to avoid that kind of stuff. So that's what we have there. What's that?
I've only got 31.
Then you need to get to work on that then.
Yeah. Yes, boss.
Maybe that's why you're not holding that aggro. Oh!
Just kidding. Thank you.
I feel some beating going on this week.
Oh, it's all good. It's all good.
Oh, I only have 24.
Yeah, they didn't have Runekeeper and Warden. Yes, that is true, but I didn't want to be mean and say, no, you can't play a class because we won't take you along or something. I wanted to be nice. But so it's a little different, but we're trying to hold as true to the original game as we can. And mostly just not break the mechanics. That's what we were talking about earlier, is avoid overpowering the mechanics so much that we basically, it's just not fun, you know. If there's no chance that you can die, it's really not a lot of fun, so. All right, so I'm going to do a quick ready check. I'll make sure that we're all here and we're all ready to go.
Everybody got your buffs and stuff?
I still have 21 minutes left on our token in my group, so I'm guessing we're good to go.
16.
Yeah, here. That's more than enough, so we're good to go.
And hope token says that one has 5 minutes left, so.
Okay. All right, there we go.
Okay. Back to 30.
Yeah. Alrighty. So whenever you're ready, Hunzi, go ahead and get it started and we'll get going. I think there is a group that comes down the stairs fairly quickly, so everybody be ready to.
Yeah. 2 seconds, by the way. Oh, never mind.
No, too late. Too late. Pull him. Pull him over. Here they come. Here they come. Here they come.
He's coming.
Kill all the adds. There we go. We did manage to keep them here. Good job.
Yeah.
Actually, yeah, very good. Well done. Okay, everybody get a jump on the boss.
Oh.
Try and pull him back in there if you can. Get him in that corner. Let him get aggro again. Keep an eye on the stairs, please.
Yeah.
Go away, stupid troll.
Yeah, Bergs use agility for damage now. Yes, you're right.
Incoming on the oops.
Coming down the stairs?
No, not yet. Not yet.
I thought I saw the shadow.
Try to turn him more into the corner so he's not hitting the group.
Incoming.
Yep. I see him.
I think he just came over the chair.
Yeah, that didn't. Yep. That kill him quick. Everybody kill him quick.
I think we managed to kill one before it got away.
That's okay. They didn't get a lot of heal though. So try to turn him back into the corner.
Yeah, we'll probably have him dead before the next one.
Yeah, we're doing pretty good.
Oh here. Yeah, we will.
Yeah, he's done.
This one was a quick fight.
He had a good
we
life.
We just do a lot more damage.
Yes. Yeah. All right, let's see what's in the box.
Twice he kicked me over the chest, and I got stuck. I couldn't get out of the chest.
Okay, well, let's see. So we have a minstrel here. So our minstrel is the lucky winner of a Mentoring the Moor cowbell.
Ooh.
Unless you already have it. If you already have that.
Shame. Shame.
You already have it?
Yeah.
Okay. Then we'll see if anybody wants to roll for it when we get there. So we have the sparkling diamond, which is for the gloves. Okay, so if you do not have the gloves for your rift set and you would like to roll for the diamond.
Can someone link the gloves from the rift set if he or she has the medium gloves, by the way, in chat? Where are they?
Well, everything's up at the rift, at the barterers up there. So, yeah.
I want to know if my current gloves are better than their.
Isn't
rift
it the
armor.
Ones I've got? What is it? The Town Savers gauntlets, isn't it?
Yeah.
Are they the crafted gloves? Are they the crafted gloves?
No, it's the Town Savers gloves.
Okay.
Gauntlets,
and they're and, okay. Right here, those right there, what I just linked that's mine, those are the crafted gloves. Those are better than the Rift gear. Why? So where did the Town Savers gloves come from?
Town Savers Rift.
Oh, those are your Rift set? Yeah. Yeah, they are. That is a yeah. That is the Rift set. Okay.
But they're not that much worse, to be honest.
They're not that much worse, but they have the set bonus for the shadow disbursement and all that kind of stuff, yeah, which is nice.
And also, for the Rift or for the Warden at least, you get both Might and Agility, which is a bug that they never fixed, but they both count towards as main stats, so I would prefer
to have that those. One. Okay. But you don't have those yet, right?
Oh, yeah, wait, I should roll, right?
Yes, you should roll. If you want those gloves, well, you should do a roll. Yeah. And yeah, that didn't work well for you. Better luck next time. 79, bam. How'd I do?
Well done.
Am I leading right now? Is that, do I have the high roll?
I think this is the one I already have, I don't know.
Nope. I'm rolling again. I'm just going to roll all the way.
He's just going to keep rolling until he wins.
It's not doing you a bit of good.
Nope.
Yeah, stop! Win. Stop! No, it doesn't count.
Grass evil?
Yeah, so, okay. Right? And actually, that's good because you'll know, because the gloves are the one item that actually for the burglar in here is really good because it the burglars get a, it's now only 25%, but it was a 50% reduction in inductions for things like turning the wheels, opening chests, and doing all of that. Yeah, it used to be 50% reduction. Now it's only 25% when they nerfed all the gear in here. Still. So, yeah, it's still not bad. It's still not bad at all. So, okay, so I win that. So I'm going to take that. So thank you, everybody. I got my piece for tonight. Woohoo! Woohoo! So, all right. I'm going to relink the rest of the stuff that was in this chest. Let me see here. Nope, not that one. That one. Okay, so that's everything else that's in there. If you guys, is there anybody who wants something specific from that list of items that you want to have to roll for or anything like that?
No. Well, if no one wants the... No, I don't, basically.
Okay.
Maybe the mentoring thing if no one else wants it, but...
Okay, well, all right, then if nobody wants anything in particular from that, I'm going to leave them in the chest, and you can all help yourself to whatever you like.
You guys
like
might want to look at that cloak for cosmetic, because it's an awful pretty cosmetic cloak.
That's the same cloak that you get with, that comes from Elrond, I think, in one of the later books. Yep. Yeah, it's the same pattern, I think.
It's real pretty.
But
yeah, but it doesn't die too well with the armor that I want, so.
The Rift set has a bonus for the Balrog fight. Yeah. Best server of all is in the U.S. is Landreval. Well, I'm sure there's probably people that will disagree, but I'll agree with that because I always played on Landy. So.
I've got an Elf Steelband loot box. Garcia, I think you dropped an Elf Steelband loot box.
Me?
Yeah.
How did I drop one?
Well, you're an Elf.
they're trolling you, Garcia.
Okay.
All right, so...
We already had the trolls.
No, Hunty, no.
I don't use them.
Throw me. It's the loot box weekend until the 8th of May.
Yeah.
But I haven't gotten anything so far.
Till Sunday night, you guys, we have an extra chance to get some extra loot boxes.
Yeah, I haven't gotten anything yet, so, yeah.
Okay, so let's see. We are we're at 7:30 Eastern, so got about another hour and a half on my show, and then maybe a little extra time depending on how we run over. So let's try to keep moving. So for this fight, just go grab all the aggro scrapper first, defenders, and then fighters. Try to tank it all right there in the same spot. So
you're gonna tank the whole lot there in the one spot.
Yep, just tank them all right there, and everybody on my target, we'll be good.
Oh, I got some marks, Hunzi. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Whenever you're ready, man.
Glad I could help.
Go get him, Ray.
God, just kidding. I gotta work on my deeds on this character. Ugh. Scrapper?
Yep, Scrapper first. If aggro gets pulled off or whatever, off tank, try to pick that up.
Defender?
Yep. Defenders.
better.
Well done.
10 out of 25.
Oh, I'm on the 11 at the moment.
Pulling him. Scrapper right here, just pulling him because he's close.
And that's just one.
Yep. This almost looks like a Moore's raid right here. Oh, that was funny. That was supposed to be a joke. All right.
I just want to take one really quick moment and thank everybody that's in the chat that is helping answering questions.
Yes,
and
I do.
Helping all the new people in the chat. It's really nice of you guys to help out. I really appreciate that, you guys.
And yes, Maywin, we are planning to move to. We'll raise the level cap to 60 for the group at some point.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
And then we will move on and do the same thing with all the stuff in Moria. So yeah, that is the plan. All right, Scrapper first, and then
before
defenders.
Before we continue, Hansi, yeah. For the lore master, can you? I forgot what skill scope, but there's a skill you can see what they're good against and what's not. What's it called? Can someone help me out here?
Say that again.
Basically, it's a skill you throw an NPC.
The one where the lore master looks and can see what their
knowledge of the lore master.
Yeah,
I think so. Can you check if they're these Gushra defenders or the scrapper, I don't care, what they are against light and fire damage.
Common fire, light, shadow, lightning, ancient dwarf, Beleriand, Westerness, and frost are all remarkable.
And fire was common?
No, they're all remarkable.
Oh, all remarkable, okay.
Okay.
Then doesn't matter.
Nope.
Thank you.
Okay. He's down.
Yeah, come in close, everybody. Actually, probably could take the... There you go. Scrapper first.
Nope.
Though it really doesn't matter. As long as you keep them all tight together.
Nice.
Sweet.
No, it's okay, Cookie. We know. You know, honestly, this is it's supposed to be a fun thing. This is not like high pressure, all that kind of stuff. So.
Okay.
Yes, and yes, who's that? Critney Fears. God, I love that name. That's awesome. Critney Fears, welcome back to the game.
Bravo!
Yes. That is bravo. All right, so there's a summoner inbound. He's going to summon as soon as... there we go. Well, maybe not. So I'm going to try this and see if we can keep him from summoning. The Mez first usually does a good job of keeping him from summoning. Just remember there's going to be more stuff walking this way, so just be careful. We don't aggro too much.
That's
too soon.
The best name ever.
I know. All right, good done. Well done. Everybody back in. Come back over here. Everybody back over here. Behind the wall, people.
I'm not a brick in the wall.
So I'll get him. Just I want to. If I get him mezzed, then he won't summon more.
Mm-hmm.
Get it. Who said burglars are no good? Nice.
They're not no good. They're good for nothing scoundrels.
Oh, is that what it is? Okay.
They're no good. They're no good. They're no good.
Burglars
are
no
good.
Nice. Bravo.
Well done.
All right, that fireworm's going away. All right, we're going to pull this group now. Yay, here they come.
Oops.
Kill them all.
Kill them!
Kill them!
Did we see fire?
Fire!
fire.
Incoming fire.
Ask and ye shall receive.
Indubitably.
Nice. Well done.
Oh, I've acquired a burglar's dagger of the third age.
Oh, how nice.
Well, we all know that's no good.
Baby, it's no good.
You should have all just gotten your 25 Goshfra.
Yep.
Yep.
All right.
Goshfra.
All right, everybody behind the wall. Everybody get behind the wall because this is a line of sight thing.
Now my hobbit can't see anything.
That's true. Yes, that's correct.
Shall I get a box?
Shall we get a box? Shall we get you a box? All right.
Wow.
I think we brought everything. That was awesome. That was classic.
Nice. Red for my group. Never mind.
What did Tiber say on live stream? There were 13,000 quests they had to upgrade with mithril ports. Or 30. 13 or 30? What? I don't know.
No. Is it just me, or is there like a fire drakeling stuck somewhere or something?
It's you.
One second.
It's you.
It's not
wow.
Me, it's you.
Are we ready to go in?
No. Okay, here.
Not yet. Hang on. Pulling this worm here.
Fire worm.
The fire worm.
Been doing the completionist thing on Evernight. Slowly doing all the quests. The problem is to not over-level too quickly. Yep.
Stone of the Tortoise.
And another... again, I hate to say it, but that's where that tortoise stone comes in handy.
That's only 100 Lotra points.
Less, I think, even.
There is a drake stuck. Is that him? He's up there on
See,
the wall.
I thought so.
Yeah, there's... No, it, there's... They're flying. They're the ones that are flying around.
Oh,
they don't
okay.
come down, though. But they will burn you if you're underneath of them.
Okay.
That's why you, is that why you're like taking damage or something and you're trying to figure out
no,
why?
No, it wasn't taking damage, but I just kept seeing like a blue health meter that was like just
right.
stuck.
Like, yeah, there was one that looked like it was stuck on that rock over there. I finally freed it. Free the
yeah,
drakes.
I wasn't losing my mind.
Can't lose what you've already lost.
For this
right. All right, hang on a second. Hang on, guys. Hold on. All right, what was that again, Bing?
We move in for this pack, right?
Yeah, for this one we move in. So everybody, we're gonna go in. Basically, we want to tank the drake. We'll kill the scrappers first, and then we'll kill the drake.
Okay. So you want me to take the drake first?
Yep. Grab the drake. Yeah. Turn everything. You know, you go to the opposite side. Turn it all around. Then we'll kill the scrappers, and then we'll kill the mm-hmm. The drake.
Yeah.
Whenever you're
okay.
ready.
Okay. Off I go.
Nice with the knock.
You're on a bonsai.
You take the drink right there, you take the drink. And you turn it all about. Oh my god, I finally got
like
a steel token!
Paper shield is not balanced to level 50 at all.
Try to interrupt that drake when he does the flapping.
When
thing.
He does?
Well, when he dies, yeah. Well, the thing was, we were supposed to be killing the scrappers first, and everybody killed the drake first, so yeah.
I thought you said to take the drake.
I said for you to tank the drake first, and then we kill the scrappers, and then we kill the drake. So, there's that. Okay, so... Wow. Right. What did I say? Let's see. No problem being over-leveled. I think questing is not that difficult anyway. Yeah, it's not, but being too over-leveled to do this stuff just makes the mobs too easy to kill.
And if you're way too over-leveled, you don't even have to kill them at all. Sometimes you can just walk past them.
Walk right
yeah, exactly. Yeah. It's like, what's this zone do again?
Yeah.
All right. So Hunzi, you're gonna be main tank, right? You're our main tank. So you're gonna grab the boss up there, and you're gonna tank him. All right.
Zogtark.
Yeah. So bring him like over here. You can bring him to like this big spot right here.
Yeah.
Good spot to try to drag him over. The rest of us are gonna be on the drakes. What we want to try to do is get some stuns or knockdowns or whatever we can do. But basically, we gotta beat the crap out of them as quickly as we can. But we have some range damage, so we shouldn't have too much trouble if they get up in the air. Okay. But I don't think we've even let them get up in the air yet. So,
all right, I'm ready.
Watch for the additional adds that will come. There will be some worms as well, so we're gonna need to clean those up also. So, David, if you scoop up whatever additional stuff may come, just kind of grab all the aggro, and then we'll burn it down.
Sure.
How do I get him? He's not.
I think it's when we
walk. When you walk over there, he'll aggro.
Before you start, I see both group need to stack up. If you.
Oh yeah,
go to me and I'll stack up us up on scrolls.
Yeah, everybody come in for scrolls and tokens. Let's do scrolls and tokens again, please.
He didn't aggro on me.
Not yet.
It's the drakes, not.
Oh, is it the drakes, not the boss? Okay.
Okay.
But you just have to be ready to pick up the aggro on the boss as soon as we aggro the drones.
Okay, gotcha. So, all right, I'll just top up my shielding here quickly again.
All right. So now here's what I want to do. If you're in group one, which is my group, take the drake on the left, unless you're Hunzi or somebody else. And if you're in group two, take the drake on the right. Yeah, Hunzi or healer is what I meant to say. So, group one on the left, group two on the right. Just try to burn down as quickly as you can before they get up in the air.
And as soon as he aggroes, I grab him.
The Captain Woris, Lariana, whatever. Which pet do you have out? Since you don't have a pet and might help. No, Captain.
Oh.
They got pets too.
Woris?
So.
Oh, he's got his.
That's Lariana. I think I'm saying that right too. If I'm not saying that right, please feel free to correct me.
Yeah.
So, are we ready?
Yeah, of course. We want to pet out if possible. That will help.
Yeah. You just got to keep them you got to keep them on passive though, because you don't want them running off and smacking things that they don't want to smack. You don't want to.
Yeah. Indeed, the mitigation one. Good.
Yeah. All right, are we ready to go?
I'm ready.
So I just grab Zogtark as soon as he.
Yeah. I'll start the aggro on these guys. Then you just grab the boss. Yeah. All right.
And you grab Zogtark, and I will grab the ads and the Drake.
Okay. Here we go. There we go. Oh, this one's stunned. Just do red. Slow him down if you can.
Come on.
Why is he running away?
I don't know.
That's what they do.
Yep, that's what they do. Okay. They run and then they try to fly up in the air. If you can't get them dead before they get up in the air, you need range damage to kill them. All right, this one's down. Kill that other drake. Get that other drake. Yep, good. Nice job on the stun. Very well done. There, he's done. Okay, clean up all the little worms. Clean up the fireworms.
Okay.
Good. Everybody on the boss? After that worm.
Still fireworm.
Yep. Yeah, get the worm.
Incoming pet army.
Stick 'em.
That's what it's called.
But why is it called like that?
Actually, they're talking about gold sellers and chat spam and all that kind of stuff. They actually have pretty good spam filters. It's one of the reasons why we don't see as many things as we do. I think there's just kind of been somebody found a way through something recently, so we're seeing a lot more of it lately, but I think they have it pretty well under control.
I right-click and report them for harassment straight away.
Yeah, that's all you do. Yeah, just report them. They ignore. Yep. Move on. No biggie. All right. What do we got? Ooh, a lot of stuff in the box here. So, all right. Well, there's some kind of scrappy crafting stuff, too, so that's not a big deal. So I'm just going to go through and get the main things that I can see for right now. So there's the first thing. So we have the glinting amethyst. So we've had boots. We've had gloves. I think this might be for the pants.
I think so. Yeah. Pants or chest.
I don't care. I need both. So.
Well, I just want to make sure that everybody knows what it's for, so that we do it. So yeah. The amethyst is for the pants.
The ranger pants.
Yes. Well, Gussie already has plenty of pants, including these, because she keeps stealing them from all the rangers. So so she doesn't need to do any pants here. So.
At the mood.
All right. So if you would like to roll for the glinting amethyst for the pants, go ahead and roll. If you've already got something tonight, please don't roll.
Wow.
Unless we get people that, like, you know, everybody's gotten everything already, or, you know, whatever, or there's just nobody that doesn't need something, you know, or whatever. So
it's all about the pants. The pants.
It's all about them pants.
No t-shirts.
All right. So I see three rolls so far. Looks like Gramp is in the lead there.
It's all about the pants, but the pants.
No. Any other rolls? Any other rolls? Going once, going twice. Sold to Adriana, otherwise known as Gamer Gramp.
Who's Sylvig?
Shelly, I can't tell you what I did with the pants.
Sylvig is Sylvig.
Okay, Sylvig's gonna go.
Sylvig needs to leave, is that what he said?
I'm just seeing the right chat.
I need to go, sorry. Ridiculous lag. I need to go to sleep.
Oh, okay. That's cool. Well, we'll continue to do what we got to do. Thanks for coming along, though, man. I appreciate it. Always good. Always good. So we have a spot open if anybody has actually got a 50 and somebody maybe wants to come join us. We have a spot open. Standard rules apply. So, all right. So there was a bunch of other things that I linked there, but I'll do them again. Because there might have been one or two things. So there's all what's left. Does anybody want anything in there in particular? There are pants here, Gussie, in case you want some.
I saw that. I have those. Thank you.
You have those pants? Okay.
Yeah.
Gussie stole those pants, too.
Got those in the last time we were here.
Oh, wow. For captains, that halberd.
The Tortorith?
Cosmetics of it. Yeah, Tortorith, the cosmetics of it. Wow.
Yeah. Is it a pretty badass looking... halberd?
Oh yeah.
Oh dude, that kicks ass.
Oh, that is cool.
I can't really see it. Yeah, that is neat though. I don't have a very good dressing room on the standard thing, but that's a badass looking thing. So okay, well, you captains can fight it out if you want. That's you know.
Yeah. So if nobody of captains wants it, I'm going to call it dips for my low level captain.
Okay, well, it's Bink or Warris first.
It's a pretty common cosmetic
first. Is it really? Okay.
At least in this level range, 40 to 50.
Okay.
God, this lightning.
All right, Wara says pass. I'm guessing, Bink, you're going to pass, yes? Yes, Bink?
That's gorgeous.
All right, well, I will give it to you then. It's all yours.
I'm literally drooling right now.
All right. I'll leave the rest of the stuff in the chest. If you would like to help yourself to what's in there, go ahead. Go for it. All right. Lotro, the only place possible where you can say the phrase, roll for the pants and not sound weird. Yeah, that's true. That is true. All right.
Is there anybody in the chat who wants to come and join us? We have an open spot.
Yeah.
As long as you meet the qualifications for the group, you are welcome to let us know and come and join us.
Well, everybody that is in the kinship at the moment is currently in the raid, so with the exception of Silvig, because they had to go. So, but we got 11, so we can work with 11. So we'll keep going. All right, so everybody remembers this, right? This is the fumaroles on our way to the end of this. So we will stay the right side of the bridge the entire time, and we'll pop the fumaroles one at a time. Remember that we want to try to get an interrupt on the fumarole early if we can, when it starts sort of trying to spit out the flames. If a fire, if a little fire flame thing gets out, ignore it. Okay, they will do reflective damage. So if you hit them really hard, you risk killing yourself. So, so just ignore the flames until we get done killing the fumarole that spawned it. Okay, so. If everybody's ready to go, Hunzi, you can lead us out. Actually, I'll just lead us out. That's fine. Because
stay on the right side, isn't it?
Stay to the right. Everybody stay to the right side of the bridge. And off we will go. I can't stealth here anyway because fire.
Fire?
Somebody say fire.
Fire. All right. Okay, here come the ads. Fire. Actually, back up. Everybody come back. Come back to this platform here. Let's kill that first set of ads first, right here. Preferably not where there's fire.
Yeah.
That's why I said back up to the platform. But hey, nobody cares.
Yeah, I'll drag him back. One sec.
It's all right.
Nobody's
listening to the raid leader. I'm losing control. Listen.
What?
There's no
talking here, so. How am I off the platform?
It's all good. Dude, we're having fun. Is everybody having fun?
No.
Oh, then get out. If you're not having fun, get out.
You're boring. Okay.
All right. Goodbye. Fumarole. First fumarole is right here. Okay. All right, just ignore the flame. Just stay on the fumarole, my target.
Fumarole. Okay.
Yeah, do not shoot that.
More dots.
All right, now just sort of there you go. Just quick attack or what is it? Just little attacks. Okay,
auto
good.
Auto attack.
That thing. All right, next fumarole right here. Interrupted. Good. So we won't get a fire.
Somebody say fire.
Fire. You did it. If silly hobbits wore boots, they wouldn't have to hot foot it. Oh, that's good.
That's just terrible.
All right, stay to the right. Next fumarole right there. Interrupted. Good.
Stupid fine, go away.
Incoming ads. Stay on the fumarole first, then we'll take the ads. Make sure you stay to this side of the platform also. Okay, on the ads.
Woohoo! Bane player.
One more ad back here.
There.
Get off the, you're on fire.
Alright, keep coming. Alright, everybody get this fumarole. It's gonna pop right here. Or, I guess not. I'm gonna stop this.
You have failed and brought the intruders right to us!
Good work, everybody. That was good. Very well done. There's the Everseer. Get a little bit of a breather here.
So, Gussie, have you learned to not attack the boss yet?
We'll find out, won't we?
Yes, I guess we will. Somebody convinced me to stop with the jelly beans, finally. What? Okay. All right. So, Gussie, we're going to have you do this side. You'll do the darklings that will come out of this hole over here. Mm-hmm. And then take care of this side of the platform for shooting, the seers as we move around, right? So you got this side. Who do we have for the other side? I'm guessing probably one of the
range, yeah, or
either one of the off tanks. Hunzi, you're gonna tank the main guy, which is Narnublat.
Mm-hmm.
So you're gonna basically
zoom type.
Yeah, you're gonna just kind of you're gonna tank him and hold his aggro and because we can't hurt him until we kill all the seers, right?
Yeah. So we need to get seers first.
So
yes, seers first, and everybody will be on my target for the seers. I'm sorry, what was that?
No fire damage, so I'll switch to make sure I got light on.
Okay. So David, why don't you take the darklings on the other side, and then you can also do some range damage to the seers on the other side of the platform when you're not doing darklings.
Okay, swapping to ranged.
Okay.
So David's going to go on the other side of this platform, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
And I'm going to hit Narnublat.
Yes. Thing. You're gonna take him and you're gonna tank him pretty much at the right at the bottom of the stairs here, I think, is where you can tank him.
Just aggro him. Don't like try to establish aggro.
Yeah, don't
just because you'll just kill yourself.
He reflects damage, right, until the seers are done?
Yeah, it's like 100% damage reflect too. Oh, okay. So it's pretty brutal.
Yeah, so you should be good with popping a defiant challenge once in a while, since that doesn't do any damage, but it does do 4-stack.
Yep. Okay.
All right, we good to go. I think we still have 15 minutes on the scrolls and more on the token, or scrolls and tokens, so we're good. So whenever you're ready, go ahead and start the aggro, and everybody else will be on the seer that is my target once we start moving on the platform.
Just go and grab him then.
Yep. Go get him, Ray.
Hey, Gamer Gramp, can you put some tar down over here too?
Yeah, I'm going to stay over here with you.
Okay, everybody on my target.
Ready to go.
You will need my aid.
All right.
You have interfered for the last time. I will make certain.
So why isn't he staying on me?
Because healing threats, I guess.
Okay.
What's the matter?
He's probably having to play a awkward game of outthread the healer, but don't kill yourself.
Next target, my target here.
Oh, that's a second stack there. No.
Don't attack the boss beyond these
You should not be touching the boss in any way, shape, or form. Everybody should be on the seers on my target. All right, next one. If you're doing melee damage, it helps to be behind them.
So I'm just turning to the right so he doesn't swing.
Last one.
No.
All right, on the boss.
We can take hitting now.
Yep.
Awesome. Just trying to get some self-healing built up.
Incoming pet army.
Sick 'em.
Good job, guys.
Well done, everybody.
And I didn't die!
And Gussie didn't die!
What kind of dark sorcery is this?
You get pants, Gussie. You get pants.
All right. She gets pantsed?
She gets pantsed, yes. Alright, so we have one glowing red ruby. And then a bunch of other stuffs. So there are all of the items in the chest. Show off those Grey Company panties. Chromite, nice. Guitar Jim, this is the Rift, actually. We are this is an all level 50 capped group. Redoing the Rift, so yeah, that's where we are. Anyway, the red ruby is for, what is it for? What's it for? There we go.
Chest, I think.
The ruby is for the chest, yeah. So if you need the chest piece, which I think you already have too, Gussie, don't you? Didn't you get the chest and the pants? Yeah, I thought so. So if you have the chest and you have, or if you don't have the chest and you haven't gotten anything tonight, and you would like to roll for the ruby, go ahead and roll for the ruby.
Oh, wow.
A lot of low rolls tonight, man. Nobody's really running away with anything.
Nope.
Here, just for giggles, ignore my roll.
Okay. Yes, we can safely ignore that roll. Yep. All right, any more rolls? Looks like Throw Me is going to get it. So unless somebody else wants to come in and try to take that.
Hashtag.
Nice.
My stomach is starting a revolution, so I'll be back in a few minutes, I hope.
Okay.
Starting a revolution.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not good. Let's.
All right, go. Okay. Just go, man. All right, so that's going to go to Throw Me. So we're going to assign that. Yeah, it's nice.
My stomach wants a revolution.
Well, you know. Oh, snort count.
I am
leaving the rest of the gear in the chest. If anybody wants any of that stuff, you can help yourself. And then we can come in the next room. Just don't run ahead.
Guitar Chim, yes, we're all running level 50 capped pre-Moria content characters.
Right.
Together, yes. To the best of our ability.
Everyone is on level. We're all like 49 and 50. We've capped with level 50, and there's a few other rules too. You can't use any legendary items.
Scrapper coming.
We can pull him. Let's pull him in. That'll be easy. But for the most part, we've been building this group up since December. People have just sort of been casually joining and saying, "Oh, that sounds like a lot of fun. I want to go try that." So, anybody who has a level 50 or wants to make a level 50 on Brandywine is welcome to come join us.
And we have cookies.
Because we are the dark side.
And mostly the reason why, in case anybody's wondering why, A, because it's really still kind of fun to do these, but B, because these are non-scalable instances. So the only way you can really do them without breaking the game mechanics is to hold on level. Otherwise, you're just too overpowered for it. So it takes all the fun out of it. I want to be part of a kin that maxes at level 50. And attacks to level 50 and does the raids at that level. If you do, you're welcome to come join us. What you need to do is you need to have a character on the Brandywine server. And you can join our kinship if you like. You don't have to. It's not a requirement. But we just need to have you in a friends list or whatever. Get a character to 50 and the rest of the rules. And the only thing is, when you get to level 50, you need to put the pocket item in your pocket that you buy from the Lotro store that disables your XP gain And you need to keep that in the pocket until we, you know, raise the level cap and move on to like Moria, which is what's planned next. So, but we're in no big hurry. So if there's anybody that still wants to do that, you're more than welcome to do that and come join us in a future raid. So
even if you want to join late for the level 60 edition, you know, that's
And if you have something that's between level 50 and 60, and you go, oh wow, you know, okay, I'll hold now. You can do that too, and then just kind of hang out until we start doing 60 stuff at when we get to there, and we'll do that. All right, let's do this. Let's do this pull here. There are defenders and fighters. Let's try to mez either run in and just tank it all right there. Yeah, go for it. No, that's okay. We're good. We got Hunzi. Cowabunga, dude.
Cowabunga!
Need to find a kin like that on Landy. There is a kinship like that on Landerval. I know that there's one on Gladden because I think Mort is actually in a kinship that's at level 65, I think, right now, or something like that. All right, there's a summoner here, so let me take care of the summoner.
Oh, Feck will be ticked if we get the bell.
Oh, that would be so hilarious. I will be so...
Well,
that will be so hilarious, but we'll see. All right,
we have to clip it.
Yeah. All right, we ready to go?
Yep.
Summoner's down. Just pull everything else. Pull everything else.
I can't pull her no more, Captain.
I'm giving it all I've got.
I think that pocket item is 250, but I'm not 100% sure. It's been a while since I bought it, but I think it may be 250. Yeah, the stone of the tortoise. I think
it's 100.
Is it just 100? Okay.
Yeah.
There
something
you go.
Like that.
No, it's
99.9. 98.6. Oh no, wrong FM. Number. Sorry.
Right. Come here, stupid worm.
I want my jingle jingle.
Jingle jangle jingle. And this is the only place that the jeweled bell will drop. Okay, so is David back yet? I don't believe he is. Can we have maybe one of the captains just tank the secondary boss just to keep him occupied?
I could bring up my bear if nothing else.
I don't have a yellow.
Megan Trainer.
Yeah.
I'm gonna slap you with a fish.
Screw XP disabler and go jingle jangle. Yeah.
Okay, sorry about that, Gus.
Look, it's Megan Trainer.
Oh, okay, he's back. No, you can put Megan Trainor away now.
Okay, I'll just put her back in my pocket.
You know, because she's all about that. She's all about that base.
So which one you want me to take now, Evil?
All right. So what we're gonna do is, since you're main tanking, you're gonna actually grab the Shadow Eater on the right hand side. So when you open the door and he starts coming out, you're gonna grab him. You're gonna pull him back into that room and tank him in there. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
David, you're going to grab the Stonebiter.
Yeah. Okay?
And you're going to pull him out here, and you're going to tank him over here, right?
Yeah, I remember that from the first time. Yep.
Okay, so you're going to tank him over here. Basically, what's going to happen is everybody's going to start damaging the Shadow Eater inside that room. All right, we're going to start tearing him down. And when we get down a little closer to where they're a little more even, what we're going to do is we're going to have everybody that's in David's group, in group two, you're going to break off when I say, and you're going to go over, and then you're going to start beating on the Stonebiter over here. Okay. Yeah. And then Gussie, you're going to kind of go be the go-between like you have been. So you, because you can pew-pew from out here and just kind of go back and forth between the two. So, and then the idea is that we want to try to kill them both within a very short span of time, like as in seconds, so that they don't spawn any additional adds. If you kill one before the other, we get a bunch of adds. So we don't want to do that.
Okay, so down together. Yes. I tank him in there. I don't need to pull him anywhere.
Nope, you're going to grab him. You're going to tank him in that room.
Yep, just turn him around.
Yep, you got it.
All right, let me...
And with any luck, we will come out with the jingle jingle, and Feck will hate us all forever.
She already hates me, so...
Oh, okay. Well, then we'll just give you the jingle jingle then, because...
I already got one, that's why she hates
me. Oh, that's why she hates you, because you already have one, all right.
I'll give him the second one.
Okay. Oh, yeah, he can go jingle 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 jingle, and that would be fun. All right. So whenever you're ready, let's make sure we got scrolls and tokens up. Yeah, we're good. I think we're good.
Our group needs a hope token.
Okay, hang on. Whoa. Somebody pop it. That's okay. Grab the aggro. Get in there.
I have one.
All right, we're good. We're good.
No way.
Stone Biter was mine, right?
Yes. Yeah. Yep. So pull him out. There you go. Excellent. Very good. Well done. Pull him back in.
Oh, he is.
Now, why is he going out there?
Well, you're going to have to get the aggro and pull him back into the room.
He's bugged.
Okay. You got him. You got him. Pull him into the room.
Oh, yeah. He's got like a...
Yeah, he's bugged.
Come out here to get his threats.
All right. Just don't be doing any damage on the stone biter.
Hunzi, you got to go through the door.
Yeah, Hunzi, come out. Come out. There you go.
He won't lock onto you until you get through the door and get...
There you go. All right, now back him up. Back him up.
He's gone bugged again.
Oh, okay. All right, well, then we're going to kill him right here. Let's just keep... We'll do it here.
Well, he's
anti-exploit.
Yep. Everybody has to be outside the room, so come out here and...
Well, it's not just that. It must be the corner then.
Okay.
That he doesn't like.
Yeah, he's not liking something, it right now.
No.
Wow,
maybe it means we're going to get a jingle jingle.
He's immune,
David. Just go into melee range of him for now, David, until he fixes himself.
Yeah, I'm ready.
All right, there we go. All right.
There we go.
Okay.
Okay.
No, see, now he's bugged again. All right, now he's good again.
Oh, yeah, and now I lost aggro, of course.
Do you only have AoE taunts? Is that the problem?
Yeah, I only have AoE taunts.
Okay.
So both then just
do it with damage, if you can.
Yeah, but he's also...
All right, well, let's just do it like this. Let's just keep doing it, okay? Let's keep doing it right here. Keep an eye on the damage. Do not damage the stone biter, everybody. We don't want to kill him yet. We need to get the Shadow Eater down first, so...
Okay, Shadow Eater.
Yes, Shadow Eater first.
Okay.
Until we get them down a lot closer. Interrupt. There we go. All right, we're about 150. So we're getting down there. So just keep going, same deal. Don't change yet. All right, group two, switch over now to the other one. There you go. Switch over to the stone biter on group two. Change over. Good, good, good. Keep it going. All right, just keep it going like this. Take them down, both of them. A little more on the stone biter. Little ease up. Oh, there we go. Okay. There we go. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. We're good. We're pretty close. Keep it going. Nice. Well done. Keep it going. Keep going. Shadow. Get Stonebiter. Kill a Stonebiter. Get him. Get him down. We got an ad.
It'll be fine.
Yep. We're good.
Oh, he healed up.
Oh, he healed? There we go.
No, we got him.
Yeah.
All right.
Good job.
I think there was a Darkling here or something, or no? That was good.
Yeah,
well
the
done, everybody.
Heal, right? But they spawn.
Yeah.
I think he's gone.
Yeah, we did it.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Can I ask why you can't kill both at the same time? The reason is if there's too much time between when you kill one and the other one's still alive, then you wind up with a bunch of world eaters that will spawn. So it just makes the fight a lot more harder.
And world eaters are nasty.
Yeah, they're not fun.
Good job, everybody. Good recovery. Well done.
All right, here we go. Good luck on the jingle. Maybe we'll see what we get. Here we go. Oh my god!
No way.
No way. We didn't get it.
Every time she falls for it. Every time.
You were such a jerk.
Come on, Gussie.
It's one of the reasons why I love so Twitch delay.
My mouse is sitting over there, ready to clip it. Just.
Nice. There is some good things. We actually got a more cowbell. If anyone doesn't have a more cowbell.
I know.
You're so evil, evil.
I do have to mentor into more cowbell, so.
Yes. There is a pair of shoulders in here. There's a pair of heavy shoulders that's a teal. So I'll link those and you guys can see if you want those. So there's everything that's in there right now.
That's heavy.
Yeah, there's no gem that drops from this one though. So, does anybody specifically want anything there?
Oh, one sec. There's Warden Shield that is not as good as mine. And okay. It doesn't look great.
The crafted stuff is just way better than from here.
There's the teal. I'm guessing nobody wants that either, those teal shoulders. So.
It doesn't match my wardrobe.
Okay. All right. I'm going to leave all these in the chest then. You guys can help yourself if you like. It's all good. All right. On to the next room. What were we hoping for? We were hoping for, it's called the Jeweled Bell. It's a very rare drop that only drops there. And it's nothing really special. It's a Guardian's...
As I told you they would, the little ones approach. I am confused.
I am confused.
They never brought harm before.
Ooh, Galaria. I sound like a giant.
Galathriel knows nothing. What has she ever done but enslave you? You must deal with
the Guardian Bell thing is a good item, or...
You have protected us so far.
Okay, so the way that this fight's going to go is, Hunzi, you're going to tank the big giant because he thinks you're a bad guy. So you're going to tank him. Really, all you got to do is just keep his aggro.
Him. Man, Corey would slap me if he heard the way I speak with some of these mobs.
That's great. So, so you're going to tank him. The rest of us are going to position ourselves at the bottom of the stairs down there, and we're going to take all of the waves of adds that come from the top. There's, I think, 4 or 5 of them. The last wave is going to be filled with, the summon, not summoners, but the, what do they call them? I forget. Anyway, the last wave is the guys that heal each other like really, really big time. So what we do is we all jump in the little corner down here, because what happens is Thrang shows up. He'll do damage from the platform there and whatever. So you need to kind of be out of line of sight from Thrang. We'll all gather up in this corner down here where the wind is kind of blowing right down there now, and kill them down one at a time. And then once they're dead, then we get on Thrang. Now, what's going to happen for Hunzi is the giant leaves, right? The giant will leave because we don't kill the giant. So the giant leaves, and then you get onto Thrang when he comes down. And then you're going to have to drag him to the fumaroles. Okay, so everybody waits basically until Hunzi drags him into a fumarole that explodes. Gamer Gramp, you're going to need to keep stun immunity on Hunzi. Mm-hmm. And And then when it explodes, then we all go in, we damage him until we can't damage him anymore, and then Hunzi drags him to another fumarole and rinse and repeat. So that's how it goes. We got about 20 minutes on the stuff, so we're probably good to go to get this started right away, unless anybody have any questions, or are we good to go?
Actually, I might put another for my group, because I'm looking at my scrolls, and I've only got a minute, so...
Okay, do it. Yes, Meg Reader, thank you, Shaman. I could not think of that damn word. Thank you. The Shaman.
Okay, awesome.
All right, so...
fine, let me...
The giant is all yours.
Buffs, and then I'll play with my food.
Who was going to say that he or she was going to do the scrolls for our group?
I don't think we need them for group one. Group two, well, I think somebody said they were going to do it, right?
Okay. Yeah. Are you ready?
No. Someone said he or she was going to do.
Oh, they. Well, you got 20 minutes. Yeah, you're good. Oh no, you need scrolls, but you don't need a token. Looks like.
Yeah, okay, but who just said he was going to do scrolls?
That was Hunzi.
Oh no, Hunzi's is in my group.
Yeah, in that case, I'll pop them. One sec.
I gotta rebuff again.
Okay.
Alright, let me reprep.
So we're good?
We're good.
Because I got two buffs I put on me that last a minute.
Okay, go get them.
So,
and the rest of us will just hang out at the bottom of the stairs here.
Okie dokie. Here we go.
You have led the orcs to us, little ones.
Come here.
The Everseer spoke true.
So I just pull him over to the side about here.
Yeah, you just keep him over there. You're just going to need to be healed.
Yep.
So, all right, adds. So let's take care of these with adds. Ms. Adventure, you're going to need to be healing, or somebody's going to need to heal Hunzi. So whichever one of you is healing Hunzi should be Ms. Because you're...
Yeah, I'm keeping an eye on Hunzi.
Got it.
No worries.
I'm going to try and put some self-healing on me as well.
Okay, focus on one target at a time if we can. And yeah, I'm not worried too much about hitting FMs tonight, so I know we usually try to do that, but hasn't been a terribly big focus for tonight. Okay.
I'm trying to put the anti-stun on myself as well.
Keep the anti-stun on him. Yep. Next group coming. These are
you
some
can
of
bring
these
the
are
boss
ranged.
Closer too if you want on the just for more healing range.
No, please don't since my AoE taunts will pull him.
He's like 100 yards away from us right now.
Yeah, okay, well that's far enough, but if he brings him in close, then I will pull him. Not because I want to, but because it just happens.
You're right.
You're on healing range, Hunzi, so don't worry about just staying
there.
Yeah,
it's all good. Just trying to stack some self-buffs on myself just to help with mitigations.
Yeah, all you're doing is just keeping the aggro and just tanking him.
You slay the orcs as well? Why? What is this?
This is not the giant I'm looking for.
Mm-hmm.
This is hard work. I could go a slice of pizza now.
I has pizza.
Share, please.
Shut up.
Yeah, when I got some meatballs from the fridge, I got hungry. That's only frame evil pizza.
It's Thursday, it's pizza night. Okay, so everybody has to bring pizza to the next raid. How's that sound?
I am confused. All right. Perhaps you are not the enemy, he says.
All right, summoners coming. So now we're going to do summoners and worms. Let's try and get to these summoners here.
Thanks, Grant, too. I believe I can fly.
All right, concentrate on the summoners first, guys. Not the worms. Worms will clean up afterwards. We need to get these summoners down, though. They'll just keep spawning worms. There we go.
Summoners done.
All right, good. So do this, everybody come to the bottom. Come down to the corner.
He must not be allowed to escape.
Everybody come down to the corner where I am, please.
We cannot defeat him alone. Only the horrors are coming. Will destroy him.
I could use some heals and too late.
Okay, this is why I said everybody gotta come down. Can we get them up? Can we get them up?
Thank you.
Alright, so... my target.
Do you want me to come and give you a hand or wait for the guy to come back?
Okay, there we go. This guy. Alright, so we have to do this as a concerted effort. My target. Everybody on my target right now. Get this first one down. Alright, first one's down, next one, my target. Try to stay in close to the wall so you're not taking damage from Thrang. If you can get into the corner, get into the corner. Next target. Oh, and I just got nailed. Dang it.
You're
all right. Yeah, I'm good. It's serious damage if you get hit by Thrang.
That was a fumeral that hit us.
Alright, last summoner, this is a defiler. Where did the defiler come from? Or not defiler.
That was a
wave of defilers.
Okay, so the defilers came and we still had that up, and then we got the other ones. Okay, alright, so
defilers are the last wave.
Okay. Grab Thrang. Let Hunzi grab Thrang and take him out to the fumaroles. You cannot damage Thrang at all until he's been hit by a fumarole. So let Hunzi get him.
No touchy.
Yep. Wait. Now hit him. Ooh. No, don't move him yet. Stay right here. That other one's
through me.
Okay, sorry. All right, he is still damageable. Keep going. All right, he cannot be damaged. Stop. Let Hunzi drag him to another one. Let Hunzi drag him off. Wait here. All right, hit him now.
He booted me again.
All right, just try to keep him in place. There you go. Doing good.
Rude bastard.
Yeah, we blew up that other one, so just...
Bah. I think he's stopped now.
Yep, take him to the next one. Stop hitting him.
Stop attacking.
Come here, mister.
You don't want to be in range either when that's the go off, because they'll stun you. Hit him now. Stop hitting. Hit him now.
Okay.
Damn it. I got a little too close.
Ooh. stop hitting. Hit him now. Okay. Need one more. Go ahead, move him. Yeah, he's slowed. He's not going to get there. Take him to another one.
Slowly.
Yeah. Wait, yeah, just wait. Wait till he's a little closer in range for you. There you go. Yeah, keep going.
Come on. Don't get close.
This
don't
way.
Get close.
Get a little
Beautiful.
Closer.
You're throwing.
All right, here
three.
We go. Hit him. Kill him.
I never understood why they put that mechanic into bosses.
Good what, job, everybody. Well done.
Explodes at awesome. Low HP.
Hey, Bumble, how are you?
Hey, Bumble. How you doing, buddy?
Why hey, do someone who, me? I look like Dennis from It's Always Sunday. Me? Do I? I don't know. Do I? I never watched that show. What, I'm
somebody Dennis tell the me. Menace.
Oh, I don't know. What did I miss in chat? Anything interesting? Even trying not to miss too much with the chat, but I'm also trying to pay attention to the raid, so I apologize if I'm a little slow to respond to chat. All right, let's see what's in the box. Ooh, okay, let's see what we got here. We have some junk.
Excuse me.
All right, so here's the stuffs. There is a, wow, there's actually another tactical crit ring in there.
Oh, wow.
So there's everything. There's the Braun Weringer, which is another tactical crit ring. And there is the Pristine Opal. The Pristine Opal is for the helm. I believe, right?
So
Pristine Opal is yeah. The Pristine Opal is for the helm. So if you do not have your Rift helm and you would like to roll for that now, go ahead and roll. I already got that from my Berg. So
will I get a roll above 20?
Grats.
29. Yay.
Nice. 30.
Oh, you guys, it's going so
30
fast.
For Gussie. Nice. All right, easy. Yeah, easy on the coins there, real quick. I got to be able to see all these rolls. So.
I think we need to roll again because I can't see it anymore.
I can. 30, 29. since I posted them. So those are the only two rolls. Does anybody else want to roll for your helm? I'm not seeing any rolls.
Nope.
I guess not. Okay, I guess David, Gussie's the winner.
David, did you get a piece of gear today?
Not yet, but I don't care.
You can have the helmet, man.
No, you haven't gotten anything either, so.
But I got two pieces of gear already, so go ahead and take the helmet.
No, don't worry. You want it, take it.
Gosh.
It's yours.
Okay.
We got to get Gussie that fancy schmancy hunter armor.
Yep.
I think everybody else is saving their roll.
In the chest.
Everybody else is saving their roll in case we beat the Balrog. Because then they'll be like, ooh, I got my shoulders, right?
Yeah, or the weapon.
It's or the weapon.
Save your DKP.
Yeah, save your DKP, everybody. Oh my god, back in those days.
Draws both right. The dazzling emerald and the fire.
So there you force, go. So. All right. Does anybody want any of the other items that I linked? I will link them again.
Quickly checking.
There's a bunch of purples. There's that ring, Braun Weringer. This ring is an ancient wedding band inlaid with thin bands of fine gold. The ring itself symbolizes an enduring bond, one that cannot be broken by mundane means. So there you go.
Well, the only reason I'd want is for the description, since it's pretty cool.
Oh my god, that Mirkwood shield is beautiful.
The shield of Mirkwood? Let's check
beautiful.
It out.
Beautiful.
Ooh, that's nice.
Ooh, fancy.
So pretty.
Ooh, sharp. Looks like it hurts.
Yeah, I can't.
It's pointy.
I can't apply it, the normal shield cosmetic on a warden shield, right?
Right.
I don't think so.
No, you can do it.
Cosmetic. I've got large shields cosmetic.
Okay. So I'm going to leave all of this. If does anybody want this, or is there two people that want something that we have to roll for? Going once, going twice.
Oh,
three times a lady.
Maybe Telemar. No. Telemar.
All right.
Snort. Sorry.
All right. Everything is in the chest.
I'll fix this up.
Everything is in the chest. So, did everybody turn in the quest that they wanted to turn in here? And, of course, get the quest called An Ancient Threat, which is to defeat the Balrog.
How come I can't turn in the quest?
This is the question I was going to ask you. I've just got a thing popped up in my inventory saying Sword of Thrain.
Yes.
So, I activate that?
You've been here before, so you probably have already gotten the Sword of Thrain, haven't you? It's a quest starter. But you've never started the quest before?
No.
Then make sure you put it in. Yeah, everybody check your overflow. If you have...
Okay.
It starts a quest called A Villain Unveiled.
Yeah.
But if you've already done it, then you can't do it again.
No.
What is the quest that this guy's got a blue circle for?
That's the Ancient Threat.
That's for Ancient Threat. That's to kill the Balrog. But you've already been here and gotten that one, so...
Okay. Gotcha. I gotcha.
So that. Because of that, you know?
Okay. I wasn't sure. Things. That's what I thought.
I thought maybe I'd missed something or forgot to do something.
Because it says using that has no effect, so...
Right.
Yeah,
right.
Me too.
Okay. Rightio. I understand. Thank you for that. Clearing that up.
All right. Let's head down to the Balrog room.
When we get down there, can we have like a quick 2-minute wrap bio?
Yeah. That's all good. Let's go down. Remember, when you go in the room, go to the left so you don't aggro the elf chick. And Gussie, if everybody wants to take like a little quick bio or get some water or something like that, go do that. It is now, I have 8:38 p.m.
Eastern
time. So we only have until shortly before 10 p.m., so we only have about an hour because our cast is coming on. So for those of you who are still in the stream and watching, make sure that you don't leave after I'm done because our cast is actually coming on next. Tonight is our cast's first
premiere
show on the official LOTRO stream, so make sure you hang around for that after I get done. But we'll try and take a shot or two at the Balrog here and see how we do. So.
All right, so we're going to go for a quick bio break.
Yeah, take a quick bio or something. Yeah, okay. If you need to grab a drink refill or anything like that, you know, more pizza. You
know. It would be a nice surprise if we got the Balrog now in the first attempt. That would be a shocker.
I still haven't got that quest yet.
All right. So, who's here that hasn't been to the Balrog before? Anybody? I'm thinking maybe Woris, because she hasn't been with us before. I think everybody else has been here in some form or another.
I've been here with you, but we've never gone further than this because we kept...
Right.
Wiping here at this point. So.
Okay. So I'll wait till everybody's back and then I'll do the quick explanation and then we'll do the first attempt.
I must admit though, to be honest, I think the run that I'm involved in tonight feels like it's going a lot more smoother.
Well, the other side of that I'll tell you is, to me, some of the fights have seemed a little more chaotic, and I think The only reason for that is because A, and no offense to you guys, as you know, you guys are doing a good job, but Feck was here, and you know, we all know Feck is an excellent player, and she's really good on her Guardian. So she does a really good job as a main tank, and she's very experienced at it because she does a lot of tier 2 raiding, not necessarily on a Guardian, but you know, she knows the class. She's really good at kind of controlling a lot of those extra mobs that come in and whatever. So it's been, so tonight you guys don't have the aggro skills that she does, especially for like single target aggro, right? So when there's stuff coming in and you need to pick up a mob or whatever, it seems a little more chaotic to me tonight. And again, maybe that's just a function of Warden, which wasn't even viable in, you know, wasn't even around Warden in this fight, right? So
single target aggro.
Yeah. At least maybe not until later. Do you guys have a better single target aggro at a higher level?
Really.
No? Okay.
Not really.
We don't have any single target, and we won't get them. Not even at endgame, we don't have them whatsoever.
Oh, wow. Okay.
We only got AoEs.
That taunt attack, which you can do, but even I've noticed that taunt attack, not the not that yellow icon, I forgot the name, David.
That Defiant Challenge.
Even if I don't use Defiant Challenge, even just the normal taunt, which I think is the fist by memory. I've noticed it's still doing sometimes two, very rarely three, of those red marks on the mobs.
Yeah.
So even that's starting to become now like an AoE sort of an attack.
Yeah, okay. Goad is at least five targets. That's the minimum in a 6 meter range.
Yeah, very small AoE, but it is an AoE.
Yeah.
Yeah. And our main, that's not an aggro skill, it's just a bit threat builder. So you gain more
just
threat.
A taunt, yeah.
Yeah, and the only forced attack aggro skill, which is very important for a tank, has, well, a standard 10 targets, I believe. Yeah, 10 targets. And you can get it up to, what is it, 20 targets, I believe?
20?
So,
as in, like, 2-0? Good lord.
Yeah, I think it's 20 with allies and stuff like that. But
okay.
I can be wrong and confused to use skills with the Guardian, but you could get a lot more, I think.
I'd have to double check on the wiki just to make sure, but I'm pretty sure that Defiant Challenge stacks 3 times, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
And when you get up to 105 and you've got your tank, or you've got your Warden, sorry, and he's got all his legendary items all maxed out and he's got all his trait trees done and he's got all his gear.
Yeah.
By the time you pop that third taunt evil, it's even Guardians can't rip stuff off the Wardens.
Yeah. Actually, Meg is saying some things in the chat. Meg Reader's been talking, and I know Meg knows her stuff too, and she said that the difference tonight, even though maybe our aggro hasn't been quite as on par, that we've been able to handle it better. And I think a lot of that is too, is as we've been doing these fights as a group more, you know, we've just become more cohesive and a little more communicative and that kind of thing. So, you know, we've been able to kind of synchronize and pick up things a little better and whatever. So
we're each learning how to play our classes in a group setting better.
Yeah. In fights that will actually kill us all, you know, because that did happen once tonight too, right? We wiped. So
well, that was when we first started.
That was before you got your ultimate lore master ad.
All right.
But the other thing with the Warden, I mean, I haven't played a Guardian, so I can't really speak too much about it. But I've noticed with my Warden, and I think David will probably agree with me because he's got the same sort of thing happening with his. The more I start hitting the target, the more I'm building up my buffs on my toon. So once I start,
We've lost Gussie.
She's been having a lot of thunder and stuff.
I wonder if the storms finally got her. Yeah. Oh, I hope not.
That damn thunder from down under.
Yeah.
Indeed.
She's been thunderstruck.
All right. Well, I'm going to do a ready check and see who else is here.
Yeah, that's
right. Just make sure everybody's back.
Everyone's doing their job. That's the main thing.
All right. So I just did that twice. Sorry about that. So let's just see if everybody else is here. Looks like a few people aren't quite back yet. So, yeah, David's not back yet. So
I'm back.
Yeah. Oh, you are. Okay. Well, you didn't click.
I've been talking
now you're
to
back.
You all the time, but yay.
Yeah. Like, wait a minute. What? Okay. I don't know. I'm just looking at the flag and going, he's not back yet.
Yeah.
Okay,
sorry. I was in another screen for a
click
moment.
Click your button, man. It's okay.
I was in another screen. I didn't see it.
All right, so we're all here, so we'll just kind of try to progress without Gussie then, because I don't want to hold up the entire group since we only have about an hour. And if she comes back, then she'll just jump back in the group and we should be good. But I guarantee you she's probably like crying right now because she's got no power.
Yeah.
So, all right, so the way that this fight, and most of you already know, but I'm going to do the quick review really, really, really quick, okay?
Yes, please.
So we're going to go in through the door. We go to the left-hand side when we go in. We'll go down there. We fight a couple of world eaters. We kill the... and actually, in the past, we've been having Gussie do the pew-pew of the Darklings from across the way. So if one of the wardens wants to just pick that up, that's fine.
Javelin, yeah.
Yeah. Hunzi, you're going to be tanking... You're going to tank the world eater on this side. I'll mez the one from the other side, and then... and then we'll just pull that one across when we need to. And then David, if you'll just take, you know, just get aggro on the Darklings and kind of try to damage them from range if you can. Anybody else who has some range, we can do that as well. Gussie just got in. She's like, yeah, she lost her power, I'm sure. Yeah. No worries, Gussie. I'm sure you're on your phone, right? So that's okay. We'll manage. So, okay, so we do that. We finish that side. We go to the other side, kind of rinse and repeat, right? So that's that. So then we have the two rooms on either side of the Balrog. So what's going to happen is, Hunzi, you're going to get to tank the Balrog out here. Okay. Yeah. So being that you haven't done this before, David, I'm assuming you haven't tanked the Balrog before either, have you?
Well, I have.
You have? Okay.
Done once before, but not on the warden.
Okay.
It's been a while ago, so.
Okay. All right. So basically, Hunzi, what you're going to do is you're going to stand at the seal. All right. Out in the front there. And you need to stay in melee range with the Balrog. So, but you can't get down into the, I forget some of this. Because I don't stand at the seal. I never do that. So basically what's going to happen is you're going to stand at the seal and you're going to keep aggro on the Balrog. And you basically want to be within melee range, right? So you should be the whole time.
Yeah.
In the meantime, everyone in group one that is not Hunzi is going to go down the path on the left side of the Balrog. Who's going to turn the wheel inside the room? Actually, I guess it really doesn't matter. What we're going to do is we're going to fight everything in those rooms, right? Because that's what we did last time. So the doors will open.
That's not what we did. Last time we went to the room, we stunned everything. We locked the rooms, got out, and locked all the enemies inside the room.
Not the last time. That was probably the time before.
That's what we tried the first time, and we failed twice.
Yes. Last time we were here, which was two weeks ago, we were more successful. Basically, we just killed everything in the room.
Yeah,
and then we turn the wheels and we come back out. That's what we're going to do again. So everybody in group one is going to go to the left side of the Balrog. Everybody in group two is going to go to the right side of the Balrog. Okay, so so know which group you're in and know where you're going and stay with your group. Okay. And then once we're done with that, once we turn the wheels, we come back out. Everybody goes back to the seal. We make sure that everything else is dead, and then we group up. We make sure we've got tokens and scrolls because we're gonna probably need at least token anyway.
I'll
I don't know about scrolls.
Before we start, yeah.
Yeah, so we'll pop them before we go in, but there will be several hope wipes, so we need to keep tokens handy and not overuse them because there's still a 3-minute cooldown, right? So so what I'll do is I'll pop one out here. Before we go in for my group, so who can do one for group two? Is there somebody who can do one for group two?
I can pop a token.
All right.
Let's see. Where to here?
Because we only have about 6 minutes left on them right now, so.
So you want to do scrolls for our group too, Evil?
Do we need scrolls? Yeah, I'll do scrolls too. I'll do the whole thing.
Okay, I'll be on cooldown then, ready to go whenever.
Right. Well, you won't. You're going to be at the Balrog. Yeah, I mean, you need to save yours for yourself in case you get a wipe without the rest of us around, okay? So you keep yours for yourself, okay? Bink, I'm guessing you have some, or somebody else has some. If we need them, we'll group up and we'll try to pop them as best as we can. All right. As a group, we have to move to the Everseer room. When we move to the Everseer room, that's about as far as we've gotten. So as a group, we all go up the stairs into the Everseer room. So everybody stay with me when we do that, okay? We're going to need to have a couple of melees need to get in on the Everseer. So David, what I'm going to want you to do when we go in is to grab the aggro on the Everseer and tank him. We got to get an interrupt on him very quickly, right? The rest of basically what we need everybody else to do is be looking for the darklings on either side of the room. There will be darklings that will appear and start to head for the purple hole in the middle of the floor on each side. You need to kill them before they get in there. If three darklings make it into that hole, then they will spawn a world eater, and we don't want that, okay? So keep an eye out for darklings at first, and then try to help with the damage. But basically, primarily, you want to be looking for darklings, and then just extra damage on the Everseer as we can. Interrupts on the Everseer are extremely important. I'll be on the Everseer myself and with the Addle and trying to keep him interrupted. So that's what we're gonna do there.
You want me to heal Hunsie or heal Group One?
The elf chick will actually keep Hunsie healed at the seal. That's according to what Feck has said. So it's been a long time since I've done that, but she said that's how that works. So we don't need a separate healer outside.
I'll follow you to the left. That.
Yes. All right, so let's give it a try. I'll do scrolls and tokens right now for my group, and eat some food if you need it. And then we will go.
Get some pizza.
Yeah, get some pizza in you.
Yeah, I don't know if we can handle the left side with those three world eaters in the room with no tank.
Okay. So do we want to have David come over with us on that side then?
So I take the left side?
Just come to the left side instead of the right for you, yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
With my whole group or just me?
Just you.
Okay, sure. No problem.
All right.
You might want to put him in our group instead, even so he gets hit by my Marcines.
Okay. Yeah, I'll switch the groups. Okay, everybody come to the door. You can watch the girl if you want. Because she gets really chatty Cathy.
What's that outfit? Prepare yourselves
and listen to my tale. Long ago, at the breaking of the Thangora dream, Thaurlok flew to this land, and I gave
chase. Good luck, everybody.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll do the best we can.
I used my Destiny perk too, just to give me an extra boost on that hype, just in case. Until the dark power rose again, and Thaurlok awoke from his secret slumber.
He was revealed to me in that moment, and I struggled with him in battle. Blah, 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 blah.
The wizards, I threw down my foe. Oh, someone go and slap it, please.
Thaurlok sued for pardon at the feet of the wizards. I'm going to send a dragon after her.
Do it. His judgment at the end of days.
We're not even going to see it.
Nope. Seek his freedom,
that I oh, there it is.
Hear it, though. If he sought to
escape. It went right for her. It's coming right for us.
I was just thinking that.
Yep.
It scared her away.
All right. Let's just do what we can with it. It's it is a really good story the first time. Absolutely. It's a good story anytime, but after a while, you're just kind of like, okay, come on. We got to get on with this thing.
Especially if you wipe like four or five times.
And then you're like, shut up already.
Let me fight.
This is a cool door, though. Probably the best door in the whole game.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
Best door in the game, yep. Because we always need more doors. Go to the left.
So I go to the left with left, you guys.
Left, left, left. Yeah, everybody comes to the left first.
Everyone's to the left.
Everyone yep. to the left.
Yeah, only once the both of the water streams are clear, then we go to the Balrog.
Don't touch the water. Just in
time. No. Is stirring. There is something well, you can do it if you want to see what happens, but it's not advisable. Or we will never be able to stop them. Protect me.
So the Darklings are what we're going for now.
Darklings first, and follow then we're... Me. Yep, and when she they gets here, we're going to get a couple of, I guess, World Eaters or whatever those are.
Things.
Yeah, those big things. Mm-hmm. I will mez the one across the way. Good. So we only have to deal with the one. Because we're only 10 in the group, right? So...
Yes.
Yeah, so we're a little shorthanded at this point, but we'll make the best of it. We'll see how far we can get. I have the aggro. Oh, okay, not anymore.
Who else dropped? We lost Sylvie.
We lost Gussie and Sylvie.
Gussie, of course.
Yeah, because Gussie. Yeah. Oh, I have the aggro, so I'm trying to keep the aggro here. So, all right, bring in the other one. Let's hit it. Bring it over. Somebody hit it. Bring it over. There we go.
Stunned it. Good job.
Watch the Darklings. Darklings coming in. Get on the Darklings if you're... Well, yeah, get on the Darklings. We don't want more World Eaters spawned. Watch from across the way, too. There's one coming in over there.
Yeah, I've got a javelin on it.
Yeah, again, this is not necessarily a brute force, kill it as quick as you can kind of fight. It's just, it's all coordination. Coordination and time in. Interrupt. There we go. I love that stun. Oh my gosh. Blue Berg's stun for the win. All right. So she's going to, clear the waters here. Just got to keep and protect her. Usually we leave Gussie behind with the pew-pew so she can protect her if we need to.
So, move with the group now?
Kill the Darklings down the other end. A couple of us will stay here and just guard the elf chick there.
I'll remain here.
Yeah, I'll stay here.
I'll head up.
Nothing really happens at the other end until she comes down there anyway, but we just need to protect her from Darklings. Got one here. Another one across the way. Two across the way.
Help!
Oh! We need somebody get David up, please. Quickly.
Sorry, I'm... accidentally press both.
I know. That's all right. That's all right. You got too close to the water. Yeah, we need somebody to res him quickly, please. I am through here. Really quickly.
I'm coming. I'm still stuck in combat, so I can't res.
Yeah, we should just not use a combat res.
Yeah, I'm in combat, though, so I can't res.
We're going to need
him. Other side, bye.
Is he up?
Yep.
Okay. All right. Everybody out of there because once. Okay. Oh, did she get delayed by a dark?
Yeah, she got delayed by.
Oh, okay. Good. 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 That was helpful. Yeah. Stay away from the pee water, please. Stay away from the pee.
I just demonstrated why.
Yes. I think you're the first person to actually die to the yellow water in here, in all the time that we've been coming in here. So there, you can wear that like a badge of honor.
No, we've had people die before in that.
Kinship first. We must hurry
to the second chamber. No, we've had it happen before, I think. Okay.
All right, she's coming over here, so I will mez the world leader on the other side again.
Yeah, okay, I think Feck died in the yellow stuff.
Oh, did she?
Yeah.
Okay. Missed on the mez. There we go. Nice. Thank you.
I was waiting, see?
No, good. No, it's good. It's good that you're there for a backup. That's excellent. Thank you. I usually hit them, but sometimes I miss. I'm missing a little more than usual tonight.
Yeah, you're lacking finesse, so
Feck did 2 misclicks last time? Okay.
Yeah, see?
I'm amazed at how much people actually remember that stuff. That's cool.
How are we getting this one down?
Ha! That was perfect timing.
Yeah, that was good.
I turned him. He should be back to you guys.
Alright, so Hunzi, when you're gonna tank the Balrog, remember the key trick there is to stay within melee range.
Mm-hmm.
And she will keep you healed. Darklings, kill the Darklings. A few more Darklings coming.
Watch the water.
Yeah, just don't go in the water.
Army of pets.
Yeah, at least the pets don't die in the water, right?
Right.
I think they all take right. damage though. Like it's weird.
She's
something is still wrong.
Okay.
Okay.
He is stronger. Wait,
what?
We must.
All right. Remember which group and where you're going.
No. Wait. Why is she going back to the center while this water is still corrupted water from entering the pool? Yellow. Hurry. It's bugged.
Some of you stand with me.
What's the matter?
Others must handle the
levers. The water is still yellow, so you can't cross until the other room.
Right.
She didn't cleanse it.
She didn't cleanse it.
Here.
It bugged.
She didn't cleanse.
Ah, oh, shoot. Yep. Oh, we're dead.
We're just dead. What the hell?
It bugged. Bugged instance. Yeah. Nothing much you can do about that.
She didn't go down there and cleanse the water. She just stayed down here at the Balrog.
Yeah, that's weird. Okay. All right, well, everybody retreat. Run back in. We'll try it again.
Oh, that sucked.
Yeah, that pretty much sucked.
We were doing good, though. So.
We were doing really good.
Well, yeah, we've got the first. I think we have the first 3 phases of that fight down pretty well. Meg says you can use taunts to keep him on aggro on you from the seal, but I don't think he is in aggro range. Okay. Make sure that when you're running back that you stay to the right in the one area where there's where the orcs are, just so you don't and same thing with the fumaroles, stay to the right of the path.
To the right.
Yeah, you silly wardens and your forest
No, everything. You're not the only one who hears a cat. Apparently, one of my cats is in the office here and decided that he wants out right now. So I have to. And so he's like,
there's a mission to turn in there if you need to turn it in.
So he's like pawing at the door and trying to get somebody else to let him out. So I will have to go. How are Runekeepers playing in a group?
Good.
Good, really good. Actually, they're excellent healers. They do great job of healing in this stuff. We had what, like 4 rune keepers the one night we did this.
That was crazy. The whole team. That was like all everybody was rune. We had like one melee that was you or something. Yes.
Yeah, it was like all rune keepers and a burglar. And that was it.
But they're also pretty good at damage, especially in red line. Their smoldering rod skill is insanely powerful.
Yeah. So for anybody who might be joining us late, I guess I can kind of talk to everybody while we're running back. Welcome to Official Lotro Stream Thursday night. We're doing a Rift run with our on level 50 group, in case you're wondering what
we're
doing.
That's the Rift of Nurzgashu, for anybody who doesn't know what the Rift is.
The Rift of... Yeah, well, yeah. I'm trying to shrink it down a little bit, you know? Little bites.
Yeah. Somebody asked earlier.
Oh, okay. All right. Somebody asked, what's the Rift? Somebody said, what is the Rift, really?
Something like that.
Okay.
Well, I don't think, you know, if you're new to this game, you don't get the
deal. Yeah, you don't know
stuff because people don't do it. So you, when you're leveling up by yourself, you know, you just don't get to do this kind of stuff.
Well, the other thing, too, is this content is all part of Angmar, right? And most people skip Angmar, right? It's one of the reasons why we're doing a lot of this was so that we could sort of highlight these instances in Angmar and have some fun with them and kind of show them to folks that, you know, maybe have just never seen these fights done before, you know, or at least not on level, you know. I will say, you know, I've come through, I've watched others go through, you know, in higher level groups, and they literally will finish this instance in an hour.
Yeah.
Because they just literally wreck everything. And including the mechanics, like them, and they wreck the mechanics to the point where, like I said, the Balrog is dead before the wheels are even turned and the Everseer is ever even aggroed. You know, they just go and it's like, oh, we can attack the Balrog now. Boom, 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 boom. He's dead. You know?
Yeah, I did that with Blood the other night. Doesn't that break things? We just ran in there and just slaughtered everything.
Well, it. I don't know if it really breaks everything necessarily, but...
It's not the way it's intended.
It's definitely not the way it's intended, yeah. It's not meant to be done like that. And if you're level 50, you can't do it like that. You just don't have enough... You don't have enough firepower to do that, so.
So one thing I've seen from when I came over from Star Wars to this game is that they have a lot of areas in this game that you just generally don't go to because they're either... Just don't follow the paths, you know. Generally,
sure.
You know, you got like people generally don't come to because you know they go to Rivendell, out to the Trollshaws, Misty Mountains, down to Region,
and it literally doesn't lead to anything.
Right. Yeah, that's just it. And people would rather spend their time and their effort as they're leveling up to go down through Region and go straight to Moria. So. These areas are kind of an afterthought, you know, anymore. But you got to remember, this was top level content. You know, this was max level content way back when. So, it is Star Wars Day, by the way. Yes, everybody. So, May the 4th be with us.
Not anymore. It's 3 a.m. here on May the 5th.
Yeah.
You're on the wrong part of the world.
I can't help it if you're living in the future.
It's,
you know?
It's 11 a.m. here.
It is 3 a.m.
Well, wow. It's just so Americans know.
In about three and a half hours.
Shout out on Facebook, somebody posted that episode. So it's,
I love it.
If it's before, fourth be with you is
Revenge of the Fifth.
Revenge of the Fifth on.
Okay, so let's just do this. Well, let's just go quick. We've got our 10, and we'll try it again. Yeah, let's just do.
1 sec. Quickly popping up to token stuff again.
Yeah. You doing it, Evil? You need...
It looks like David's got it for group one, so somebody do it for group two, and then we'll just get right to it. Everybody knows what we're doing here, so...
Okay.
Yeah.
Randomly, it's also Lunch Lady Day, so the lunch ladies at our school made us chocolate strawberries. Oh, that's cool.
Awesome.
Yeah. Quick check. Group one is taking the left and group two the right?
Yes.
Okay, got it.
Ready check? Did I get a ready check in there? Yeah. And we are green.
Check, check. One, two,
we are
check.
Go. All right, I'm going to start her off.
Just so you guys in America know, because I'm living in the future, I can now tell you that in 3.5 hours for you, Trump will decide to launch some nukes, so... Yeah. Enjoy it as long as it lasts. Prepare
yourselves and listen to my tale. Well, you know, on the 5th, there's the American holiday Cinco de Mayo, because apparently Americans celebrate that more than, you know, like, Mexicans.
Yeah, I don't get that.
Don't we, like, celebrate St. Patrick's Day more than the Irish?
Exactly. Listen, we will celebrate anything.
We celebrate anything because we commercialize it and sell everything, right? That's why they call it a celebration. See what I did there?
Yeah. Why do you think there's Thaulok? Down my foe,
defeated but not slain. Oh my. Thaulok sued for pardon at the feet of the wizards. They deemed he should be imprisoned where he could await. What was that about where we had to listen to her talk four times?
Yeah, that was me. Sorry, I jinxed it.
All right, well, here's the deal. Like, we started that fight roughly around quarter of, right? It's now 25 minutes later after one try and fail. So I think we're going to do this next run. And if we don't make it, I think this is probably going to wrap it up for us tonight, because I don't think we'll have enough time for another one before our cast needs to come on. So. So this will be our last attempt for tonight. And I know Gussie's probably like, I need my pants.
Well, she already had a shot at the pants. The only thing
she already has the pants now
will be the shoulders and the weapons and shields. So no chance for pants.
Gussie, I think, has three pieces to the set. So yeah, she's in good shape. So gotta get Gussie that set of armor.
You have come just in time. Thaulok is stirring. There is something amiss. We must purify these streams, or we will never be able to stop them. Protect me.
And please don't get too close to the pee.
Follow me. They will do everything they can to stop us.
She sure takes her time, doesn't she?
Yeah. I think she took lessons from Sarah Okart. Yeah. It's Sarah's mom. Alright, on the first one here.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Dang.
What happened then?
I don't know, but... Just, he got some move off.
Am I still here?
Bring in the other one. Yeah, you're still here.
Yeah.
Good.
A lot of Darklings coming in from the other end, by the way. We need to be on the Darklings, too. Clear the
waters here. Well, everything froze for me, so I wasn't able to get in.
Oh, you couldn't get into the room?
Yeah, my whole client froze and I couldn't move whatsoever.
Oh, okay.
So you're not even in here.
So he's not even in the room. No.
I'm outside.
Okay. Oh, man.
I saw you weren't dead, so I assumed that meant that you were in the room, so... That's all
right. Yeah, well, in this case, it was more, just completely frozen.
So we can't do nothing unless we completely die, really.
Yeah.
Jesus. Sorry.
You're cursing us, David.
I know.
I'm joking, dude.
Wait, quick check. Won't we be able to reset it if you go to the doors, or won't it reset?
No.
Okay.
So we're just going to have to continue along without you for the time being. All right, yeah. Some people stay to... Oh, she's done we already. Let's keep going. Wow, that was fast.
Yeah, if you get that mez on the second one and then just let it sit.
Dude, there's a Darkling that's aggroed on David behind the door. That's funny.
What did I do to do?
I don't know, man.
Must be the pork chops.
Yeah,
we could all suicide, but then we'd all have to run back, and that will take time, and you know, so at this point we're gonna do this with nine. We're gonna try and nine man this.
We must hurry to the second chamber.
So quickly now. Hey Bink, you think you can grab all the aggro on the left side of the on the left room?
I don't know. I mean, I don't have a lot of abilities to hold aggro.
Yeah, I know.
I could try with my bear if you think. But...
Well, yeah, actually, we got Drangdahl. Yeah, you could do that. If you want to try to pick up all the aggro with what's in there and either run it around until we can slowly, you know, burn one down at a time, maybe. That might help. We'll see how it goes. Whatever. We'll just try. Hey, Ski, how are you? Good to see you. All right, let's bring the other one.
Purify this shit. Fountain as well.
Bring it over. Bring
Do
it over.
Do not let your guard down.
I've got it.
Yeah. So this will go... Well, at least she came over here this time.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, she's already purifying.
Yeah, she's already started, so that's fine.
So which side am I going to? With you on, you go to the right side?
What's that?
To what side do you want me to go to?
You're in my group, so you're going to the left side. As you know, that's where you should be going anyway. Oh, look, I have the aggro. Nice. How do I do that? All right. Darklings.
Darkling.
Yeah, she's got to purify still, so. All right, so left-hand group.
I am through here.
All right, let's go.
We must continue.
Okay, so you need me in the middle where Feck was,
yep,
correct?
Yep, you're going to get on that seal, and you're going to tank him out of that seal.
So, stand on there now, and I'll start throwing some buffs at myself, I suppose.
Yeah, and you can't get down into the middle until the center is cleared.
Purified.
Right.
Yep.
So you just tank him from there.
Mm-hmm.
Something is still wrong. He is stronger. We must.
So I can try and mez one of these world eaters over here too, if need be.
We must stop the corrupted water from entering the pool. Hurry!
All right, I'm gonna mez the one in the back on the left. He's down. Let's try to do these one at a time. Go greens. Keep the healing up. Or not. There we go. My target, focus on one at a time. Interrupts, if we have them. Go greens.
So yeah, all I can do at the moment is just...
That's fine, we're doing okay, we're doing just fine. Okay, another one just came in, interrupt.
He just pulled me in. He just pulled me to the ledge, evil.
Okay. So like you're dead in the water. All right, we're pretty screwed. Because yeah, he'll end up killing the elf girl, and then we're pretty much done. So, yep, there we go.
Yep.
No worries.
Why did he pull me?
I don't know. I'll just check your log, see if you can figure out what happened, and that's that.
So we're done, right?
Yeah, I think we're gonna be done for tonight. Oh, look, the door's coming down, and I'm trapped inside. That's okay. We're
Wait,
done.
Even I got killed. How's that possible? I'm outside.
Hope wipe.
Because he kills everyone?
He kills everybody, yeah. Zeus says, you still got 42 minutes. Yeah, but my show was supposed to end 18 minutes ago. So, we are running a little bit long, but I don't think we're going to push our luck. But I don't know. I mean, hopefully, well, obviously, we knew we were down to 10, and then, of course, we lost our second tank, too, so that didn't help very much. But the thing is, we have locks, and one of the things that we have not been able to try to do is to do a second night before things reset. Now, this will reset on Sunday night into Monday morning, right? So I don't know if there's a possibility that maybe we can get a group together this weekend and try and do this again. But
if you're going to try to set a time, maybe like sometime in the middle of your Sunday morning stream.
We could do like that if everybody's game for that.
People in Europe.
Well, the problem is the West Coast folks, because they're still asleep like Gussie, you know.
That's why I said in the middle, not in the, right.
Well, maybe we could do that. Maybe we set it for like maybe around noon or something, like maybe noon Eastern. I don't know if anybody's available then or not. Actually, you know what? No, I'm going to tell you what. This Sunday will not work for me. I actually have a work commitment that I don't. I honestly don't know if I can do that stream Sunday morning, so that may not work.
Saturday?
Well, actually, this weekend, now that I'm thinking about it, is going to probably be a no-go. I can't commit to anything because we have a disaster recovery test that we're doing this weekend for my real job. So unfortunately,
this
I can't.
Isn't your real job?
No, this is not my real job. So maybe someday, but not today. So we'll see. So yeah, I'm guessing that that means it's probably not going to happen before raid locks reset, but you know, maybe Sunday night. Sunday night would probably be the only time, because at that point all that stuff will be done. We could do something Sunday night, but I don't want to. Obviously, everybody would need to. I'll put something in the chat or in the Discord, well, and
just put a time, because yeah, otherwise then people can try to work around it.
Okay, so mm-hmm. I'll get a time for Sunday
if
evening.
If it works or it doesn't.
Yeah, right. Know. Exactly, and then that way everybody can at least say, okay, well, we'll try for 7 o'clock on Sunday or something like that. We'll see what we can do.
Yeah.
Get evil partnered. Yeah, well, that would help. That would help. But we're getting there. We're little steps. My channel is actually affiliated now, so that's a big thing. And you know,
yay.
Yay. No, I honestly there's affiliated now. And honestly, what I'm going to do is I'm going to give a big shout out to like everybody that's watching, because there are so many of us as LOTRO streamers, not only that are here on the official channel, but others that are not, that have gotten into the Twitch affiliate program, and it's really, it's all because of all of you coming to watch our streams and supporting our streams and supporting this channel primarily. And we do other things too, but I think a lot of the folks that that are around, involved with streaming LOTRO and in the LOTRO community, you know, we do that a lot, and we're a pretty tight-knit group, and everybody really helps each other out. And all the viewers, you guys are great, because, you know, you coming to watch our channels and support us really helps with all that. So Gussie was trying for partnership, and you know, so you know, we have somebody else who is at that point, you know, as a LOTRO streamer that you know is looking to be partnered. It's been really good. She got some great feedback about that, so that was really good too. I'm sorry that she wasn't here for the end of the show too, because but you know, power issues, it happens. So so thanks everybody for being, you know, supporting this game that we all love to play so much, and you know, being here to help support the streamers that are putting it out there. The game has definitely grown quite a bit, I'd say, in the last, you know, well, I've been streaming since October, and we're now in a little more than seven months, and in that 7 month time period, I've seen tremendous growth in the game. Because of the awareness that's come from the people that are streaming it much more regularly. A lot of folks, I've seen some very big streamers come in and stream the game now. You know, if, streamers that are already partnered. We have Stina, of course, who is another, for those of you who haven't checked out her channel before, Stina Plays. You know, she is now partnered, and she is a big LOTRO streamer as well. You know, and so there's a lot of visibility around the game. Now we have 10th anniversary has brought even more visibility to the game. You know, we have Mordor coming up later this year. So a lot of people are very excited about that, and we're really looking forward to that. I will also mention that, yeah, Stina is big time. She is great. I love her stream. And I you know, she's such a great person to watch and to just talk to, and she's awesome. I will mention this for those of you who missed some things on Cordovan's stream today. I'm not sure if there's been any additional official words, but let me check real quick, because we have our communication thing going on. Cord said something about possibly an official sort of last minute announcement, big announcement tomorrow. So yeah, definitely maybe, keep an eye out on social media. Keep an eye on Twitter. Keep an eye on Facebook, that kind of thing, to keep an eye out for an announcement for possibly a stream, like a quick stream, or possibly just an announcement that's going out. But Cord was talking about possibly doing a short stream tomorrow for some kind of an announcement that they wanted to make. We don't know anything about it. They weren't 100% sure if that was actually going to happen tomorrow or not. But, you know, so keep an eye out on that. I'll bet it's the Mordor music guy. Oh, could be. That's an interesting theory. Cool. I honestly have no idea. They don't tell us anything. We're not privy to that kind of thing, even though we're streamers on this channel and stuff like that. Is there a chance that we already know what it is? I don't know. I will just all have to wait and see. but
evil, that was a pun.
We'll have to chance it.
I know that was a pun. Yeah, we'll just have to chance it. Yeah. So, he said he would be streaming the announcement when it is official. Yes. So there was it was not official yet. So there wasn't anything official about any kind of a stream, but keep an eye on social media announcements and stuff like that for those sort of things. So, Ark's having his debut in less than an hour. We really like the stick and support. Yeah, if it's late for those of you, I know. Yeah. But thank you for coming and hanging out and watching tonight. I will say thank you for Gussie Moose as well, because she was in here. You know, we try to do this on Thursday nights because it gives us a nice long run of time to be able to try to do these instances, not only for us, but so that all of you can see them. We did Fornos last week, which was awesome. That was so much fun. And you know, even that's a scaled, though it's been scaled now. We did it on level at 50, and it was still very much a lot of fun. So it was really, really cool. You're welcome thanks for everybody that came along tonight. Thanks for those of you who jumped in kind of last minute, and that kind of thing. So that's always helpful. Again, the level 50 kinship stuff that we have going on, or at least the level 50 raids that we have going on here, are on Brandywine. So if anyone is still interested and you want to join that, we'll be doing these for a while. As you see, obviously we keep dying. So, that kind of keeps us from moving on. So there's that. So if you're interested in that and you want to create a character on Brandywine, then you can get in touch with us. The kinship is called Play It Again, and you can get in touch with me, Garrido, or any of the other officers in the Play It Again kinship, and we can get you in there. You don't have to be in the kinship to come and run with us, but it does make the communication a little bit easier. Gamer Gramp is an officer as well, so he can invite to the kinship. Gussie Moose is also an officer, so... you can check us all out on streams and stuff. I'm going to do another, wrong window here. Hang on a second. So this is the list from today. So you got Gussie up there. You got me up there. Again, stay tuned too, because our cast is coming up after here. What's in my presences? You know what? I don't want to do them now, because then I give credit in my room and it's kind of hard to synchronize that over there. Cause then I got to tell people, you got to go over to my room or something. And I don't want to do that. So my next normal usual stream for LOTRO, big LOTRO stuff, is Sunday morning LOTRO cafe. And that usually starts around 9 AM Eastern. I have a work thing this weekend. I may not be able to run that stream, but, you can watch, my media, either my Twitter or, my Discord, all that kind of stuff. I'll send something out when I have more definitive understanding of whether or not I'm going to be able to do that on Sunday morning. But you know, check for it and watch for it, and hopefully we can do that for you all again this weekend too. And maybe Sunday night we can put the band back together, and we can get this Rift group done and get that Balrog dead. That would be nice. So there we go. So I think that's going to do it for me for tonight. So I'm going to call it quits, but thank you everybody for hanging out and watching. I know there's a lot of folks in here, and it's been a really awesome day, for all this, and, good luck on the DR test. Yeah. Thank you very much. Yeah. They're always a blast, let me tell you. So we'll see how that goes, but, thank you everybody for hanging out and watching. This has been, The Dark Side with Evil Twin. It was a burglar thing. That's why I came up with that in the first place. So, I have to change that. Let's see. Got to turn that off. We got to turn that on. And let's see. Where's my... I'm trying to find my stuff. There we go. Got it. That's better. So here I am. Yes. Yeah, thanks. So thanks for hanging out. Send some love Gussie's way once she gets her power back and she can come up and hang out with us again. So that'll do it for me, everybody. Thanks very much for watching. Have a great night. Make sure that you hang around. In about a half an hour, our cast is coming up on official LOTRO stream with his debut show here. So be sure to check that out. And I will see you all again, hopefully really, really soon. Keep playing the game, and we'll see you soon. Good night, everybody. Take care.